go out of the room and your ears would be pounding, your head would be pounding.
Oh, it looks great in pink.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's great. Don't get a hold of Robert. Don't do it.
Just a little highlight reel.
Poems.
I love it.
We try to make things fun, as much fun totally as possible.
Fun. Totally fun.
So, big shout out to Mike Zecca for the wonderful video, as always.
Mike Zecca?
Zecca.
Zecca. Mike Zecca, you're awesome. I loved it.
So, we are live with the beautiful Christy Hemme. Welcome.
Thanks
for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem. Our pleasure.
Asylum.
So we're just monitoring the chat. We're just making sure everything's getting shared all over the place. Everything's looking good.
Yep.
And we are going to bring in our first guest, Mr. Dan Gleason.
And she's got trading cards too, Dan. Sorry.
Oh boy.
Yes, I do. I got a box.
He'll want to see them.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
So guess what?
What?
You are the very first virtual fan that I could talk to, actually, like, see you.
Oh, thank you. I love it. I love watching. You were one of the best.
Aw.
You know? I feel like one federation didn't take advantage of what you could do compared to another, but that's personal opinion. My question for you is, all your travels all over the world, what you do, I'm a chef. That's what I do by trade.
Okay.
What's the best food? Where would you love to eat all the time?
You know, to be honest, it doesn't matter where I went, what country I went to, I wanted to eat their food. And I just would immerse myself in all of it. But guy, I mean, which kind do I like the best? Italy. That's pretty good. Awesome. There's so much. I just love food and I love trying everything. So
it is. Yeah. And that's just being a foodie. You want to try everything. Italy, the homemade pasta, everything there is just great. And Japan, I keep getting Japan, a lot of people.
Anything new.
Yes. And which, so, and another thing is locker rooms. Which locker room did you like better, WWE or TNA?
So I like TNA better, but not because like the girls there were better or anything like that. Just that we grew that division from its inception. Like there was only a couple girls in that locker room. And then when they started talking about having a division, we were involved in the process of who would come in. And then it was just like, you know, building something new and magical and special and meaningful. It was just like we were all very, very close. And I was in that locker room for a really long time. So yeah.
So you picked up a lot. So you clearly could be a booker or anything, because you sounds like you started from the beginning and worked up. I mean, you
did
do it all.
Yes. I mean, I started from when I was just managing, and then I eventually was in the office behind the scenes. So in creative.
That's, The one thing going from watching you from the very beginning, because I watched from you from the very beginning all the way, is watching you, I feel in TNA you grew more and they let you do your character more the way you wanted to do it compared to having someone micromanage your character.
Yeah, but you know, a lot of that too is having time. Like when I first started in WWE, I was so green. I didn't even know what my character would be. So it helped to have them help nurture that, you know? And then when I got into TNA, I just started to understand the business better, understand all of it better. And then I could play, you know, a lot of the girls that start in the indies, by the time they get to the big company, they know who they are and what they want to do. And, you know, it's easier to step in and be that character.
And you started at the top and we're, and it's like you started at the top and worked your way down instead of down to up.
It was and, so
and it is. And there's people that do that and you did it well. I mean, because it, I mean, you learned, you didn't come in at the hot head thinking, ha ha, I'm the top number one. I start number one. You were very humble watching you, just watching you, you know?
Yeah.
And it was great to see that.
Yeah. And I wouldn't have it any other way. I really loved my journey. It was unique. You know, indifferent.
It could be a movie and it really could. It could be because it just like any other one, you literally just fell into it and then it just you would took off. So which trading cards do you have?
Oh man, hold on. Let me find these guys. I've got a hodgepodge. I found this box and I text the guys, hey, I got a box of trading cards. Okay, so I've got this guy.
Okay.
You know, these are bench warmer. Do you know bench warmer?
I've never.
They're like the bench warmer cards.
Okay. I like your first one. Can I get that autographed to me?
Totally.
And then I'll just send the money over to David Gold. Not a problem.
Yep. To Dan. Do you want it a certain color?
No, it doesn't matter. Anything you feel looks good.
Okay.
Yes, and to Dan, because it'll stay in my collection.
Love it. Okay. That looks cute.
Thank you very much.
You're very, very welcome.
And thank you, David Gold and Rock and everybody. I got to get to work. So I'll see you guys next time. And I hope to see you in real life. Meet you in real life one day, Christy.
One day. Thank you, Dan. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. See you guys later.
Bye. See you, Dan. Your first.
It was my first. I realized that when I saw his face. I'm like, oh my gosh, I haven't like sat and talked to somebody in a really long time. It's such a weird world we're in, you know?
Yeah, I mean.
It's very different doing the virtual and not being able to talk to them.
Yeah, because you're just sitting there pretty much linked to a chat.
I'm talking to the screen, but I'm not able to like see their face. And I definitely like seeing their face better.
I agree. That's why we put this thing together to bring everybody together. So we got David coming in next. And make sure. Yeah. And he got your tape. Called the tape 8x10. I assume that's tape. How's it going, David?
Hey. What's up?
What's up, dude?
Nothing.
Where are you?
I'm in Cleveland.
At home or at work?
Yeah, I'm at home.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Actually, we technically met at the other one. I got your Playboy last time.
Oh, cool. Yeah. And I couldn't see you. So how would I know? Right.
So I have a couple questions if I can.
I have answers.
Can I get a late happy birthday? My birthday was last Friday.
Happy birthday. This is like a crazy week of birthdays. It feels like everybody's having a big birthday this week. Right. It was last Friday. That was just a couple days ago?
About a week ago, yeah.
A week ago. Okay.
Yeah. Happy birthday. So, and David Gold and I share the same birthday.
Oh, wow.
And then the second question is, what was the story behind why you used Walk Idiot Walk in WWE?
Well, it was given to me. I actually liked the bounce of it was exciting, but I was like, wait a second. What does it mean anything? But it was given to the whole Diva Search. So I just took the song that was the Diva Search's theme song, which was that song.
That's right. It was. I forgot about it that. Was.
So they kind of, and they did the same thing the next year with Ashley had taken. It was give him the best.
Oh yeah.
Remember?
Right. What's
the name of that band?
Obviously.
No. Oh, was it?
It's Foo Fighters.
Foo Fighters. Yes, oh. You're right. He had to pop in.
Oh yeah.
The answer.
And R.I.P. Ashley, by the way. My third question.
Yes.
Is you in high school and or college were a cheerleader and you actually went into majoring in dance, right? Why didn't you follow that?
I ended up being a professional dancer. I toured with a dance team out of high school. And when it came to going into college for all that, it really wasn't, I wasn't going to accomplish anything in college. I didn't have a vision for college. I knew I wanted to be in entertainment. So to me, it was like, okay, what? I'm going to go chase a college degree in wherever. And I might as well just move to LA and go after what I wanted. And I moved there and I was like, okay, I'll do the modeling, dancing thing. But it really wasn't my passion. And it wasn't until I found wrestling that I was like, oh my gosh, this is my passion. I fell in love with it. Like just head over heels in love with it.
I'm 32 and I still haven't found what I want to do with my life. So I'm just wondering, you know, you majored in dance and then yeah. A wrestler. I'm majoring in music, but I don't know what I want to do.
What is the thing that you love the most?
Probably music. That, you know, what I'm majoring in, but I don't know what I would want to do with it.
Well, there's a lot of different jobs you could have in music. And if it's the thing that just lights you up and turns you on, then that would be your passion. And I always chase my passions. So, like, I love entertainment. I didn't know what part of entertainment I'd be in or fall into, but I just chased entertainment, mm-hmm. You know? And even to this day, I moved behind the scenes and now I write and produce. And that's what in the end of my wrestling career, even with TNA, I had moved behind the scenes. So I'm still chasing that thing that I love. But if you love music, then there's something in there for you, especially if that's your passion.
It is.
Yeah. I mean, you may think that you don't know, but it feels to me, I've only talked to you for a few minutes, it feels right. To me like you do know.
I guess. But yeah, that's about it. Thanks for signing my Playboy, by the way.
Oh, you're welcome. Okay, so I'm signing this guy for you?
Mm-hmm. I forget what I got on it, on the inscription.
What David would you like it to say?
David would know. Gold.
If you can sign it for him, he'd like it to say to Dave. And then he wants you to also put from the 2006 knockout of the year.
That's right. That's what I had in my PB.
Love it.
And you're a beautiful girl. And congrats on having kids and all that.
Thanks. That is so sweet. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So here's the guy. And I'll put it in my pile.
Thanks.
And I think you should chase it. I think you should chase your passion.
Will do.
Mm-hmm.
David, you take care, buddy.
Yep, you too.
We'll see you later. Real quick, our first guest, Dan, he also got one of these.
Oh, yeah.
And he would like that signed to Dan.
Hey, should I be putting these guys in these guys?
You can do that later.
Later?
Yeah, after they're dry.
Sure. Okay, so to Dan.
Yeah.
Dan the man.
Did I send you a pink pin?
You did. Oh, that'll look good on there. Yeah.
Yeah. Try it.
Totally.
We'll start a trend.
I love a trend. Here we go.
Beautiful.
Awesome.
Looks good.
Awesome.
All right. We got stack. We got Glenn coming in next. Glenn also got your collage.
Cool. Here,
and he may want a card. So I'll let him talk to you and
tell you.
What's up, Glenn?
Hey, Christy.
Hi, Glenn.
Hey, very, very cool to meet you. By far my favorite knockout diva, whatever you want to call it, of all time.
I'm all of the bits. So nice to meet you, too. Where are you?
I am in a small town in Louisa, Kentucky.
I love Kentucky. It's beautiful there.
Yeah, we got a pretty good basketball team, too.
Oh, good.
Not too good this year, but maybe next year.
Next year.
I have a couple questions for you.
Sure.
First, so when you first started your career, who was the first person that you looked up to?
Well, when I was going through the diva search, I actually had Trish Stratus's doll, and I kept her doll in my luggage. And she was like, I felt like it was like a little good luck charm. And then also when I met Amy, Lita, I really looked up to both of them a lot. They were in the locker room. And then one of the first girls that I had met in the locker room was Gail Kim. And she was so warm and so kind and just, you know, I knew nothing about anything. And so just having that, you know, she gave me her phone number, said, call me anytime you have any questions, and just tried to teach me. Molly Holly, she was awesome in the locker room at the time, and she was really great. Took me under her wing a lot as well. Lisa, Victoria, her too. I got so many, see?
So what's one of your biggest pet peeves?
In wrestling or just in general?
General.
Well, when you said that, the first thing that popped into my head was disrespect, but that's also a big thing in wrestling is just respect. I like people that are respectful of other people. And I think that that's really important. I mean, you're looking at the crazy world right now. And I think there's a lot of disrespect for just people and the way that they think. I think even though the world is so polarized, being accepting of different points of view is important and respectful of people.
Absolutely. I agree.
What about you?
I really don't know. I don't know. Probably about the same thing. Disrespectful people. I don't care for it at all.
My husband would say bad drivers.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
That drives him nuts.
We see a few of those a lot. Where I live at is on the border with Ohio and West Virginia. So we always talk about the Ohio drivers.
Oh, and they're like crazy drivers.
Like, oh, they can't drive.
Yeah.
So my last question is your finishing move, the FFG. Who came up?
Yes.
Was that you, or was that a you thing or somebody else? Or
so I had the move. It was actually a dance move that was from the ground down. And I had done it during the diva search actually. And then I said, hey, what if I do that off the ropes onto a person? It could be a great finisher. Yeah. And then Mike Tenay, you know who that is? Mm-hmm. Mike Tenay named it one night when it was very late and we were in a bar and everybody thought it was the most hilarious name.
Yeah, it's very cool.
And the next day, he said it on TV, so it stuck.
Awesome.
Okay.
Okay, that's all I have for you.
Thank you, Glenn. Okay, so do you want me to make this to you?
Yes, to Glenn with one in.
Yep.
And whatever cool, awesome thing you want to put on there.
Okay. This is a fun collage. Okay. For Glenn. One N.
Yep.
Great. Those two N-ers.
Yeah. I get confused with that a lot.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Like, come on.
Yeah, it's one N.
Thank you. Glenn, thanks for stopping by, and I'll try not to hit you on the road when I'm driving.
Thank you, Rocky. Thank
you, Glenn. Take care, buddy.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye. I definitely like this better.
Are you sure?
Yep.
We can go back to the other way if you'd like.
No, I like this way better. It's nice.
Well, I'm glad you're enjoying yourself.
Totally.
So we got Danny
more
coming
personal,
up.
You know?
It is. It's an experience. It's not just a piece of paper with your name on it.
Yes.
That's what we're trying to give. We got Danny Ibarra coming in, and oh, wow. He got three Playboys. He marked each one.
Are they in the stack?
I'd say they're marked.
They were mailed in the box you got today.
Okay.
I think it's in a postal envelope. I don't think I opened his particularly because he had them labeled.
Oh, okay. Let me see here. So what would they be labeled? I've got Zach, Doug. Dan. But that's just on this guy.
Let's see.
What's his name?
Danny.
Danny. Was there another envelope that had like a separate express envelope that I didn't open? I left it taped shut.
No. Everything was open.
I might have opened
it. Sale for sale. You have two for sale. So I think those are probably.
They're sold. I'll tell you about those. Let me
remember. Dawn. It's not Dawn. But
no.
Dan.
No. We'll figure it out.
Let me get with, it should have been in, if you can check the box one more time as well, mm-hmm. There should have been an express, it's like a, one of those
mailer.
Flat envelopes, and I didn't open it. I think I left it taped shut.
So there was envelopes.
Some empty ones, and then there was one that had stuff in it, I think. Okay. I used the empty ones to kind of shield everything.
I might have pulled it out.
Okay, you might have taken it out of that. Okay.
I probably pulled it out.
Okay, was there any labels inside of it? Okay, he'll be able to tell you how he labeled them then. So that'll work.
Oh, okay.
Geez, now that we got that out of the road.
Hey, how's it going, Rocky? How's it going?
Good, Danny. How you doing, buddy?
Hi, Danny.
Hey. So I labeled mine. So it was like in a envelope. One was marked to Danny, and then one was for Jeff, and then the other one's for Antonio.
Danny, Jeff, and Antonio. I don't have that here.
You
look in the box, but I'm pretty sure it's empty.
Yeah, I think I left yours nice and packed up, Danny. I didn't want to mess with the, it was.
Are you
nice.
Sure that you sent them in the box?
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't have any other ones. Oh, you got, where else? I don't have any. I can tell you everything I have. One, empty. Blank.
There was nothing on that. Okay, that one was probably Danny's. Then, if there was nothing on it, the note might have fell off.
Zach.
Yep, he's coming later. We have that. That's fine.
Doug.
Yep, Doug will be here later.
Will.
Yep.
This one doesn't have anything on it.
Okay, that's probably one of Danny's too.
Okay.
If it's in, yep. So there's two.
Don.
Yep, he'll be here momentarily.
I don't know what this is. It just says Dan.
Okay. And then you can take one of those other ones because Danny, mine were in really good shape too, like brand new.
These are two for sales.
You can use one of those and then that'll cover his three. Danny, mine were like brand new too. So.
Yeah, these ones look really good. This is like fresh. Steve, this is like a crinkly.
That probably fell off. You can put that on one of the two sale ones.
Okay.
All right. That was a big thing.
Sorry. That kind of stuff happens when we got a bunch of stuff in a box and people are shaking them around.
So let me tell you a story why you're going to go ahead and do that. So I was born and raised in California. Mm-hmm. I moved to the East Coast for, kind of like a job thing. And then I came back the month before the pandemic hit. Not even the month. It was like the week before the pandemic hit.
Back to California?
Yeah, back to California. Okay. I was super excited because the wrestling store in LA, they had
Amy and Gail.
Yeah. So I had all three of you. I was like, man, this is just like perfect timing. I'm going to get to meet you in person. So yeah. I ended up getting all the Playboys from a year ago. And I made sure I got like the mint ones and everything. One for my brother, one for my best friend, and one for me. And then you had to cancel because of the pandemic. Yeah. I was like, oh. And luckily, the guys from the asylum, they're so awesome with all the meet and greets. And I was so excited when they booked you. So that way I can actually get the magazine signed.
Yeah.
So I like taped it up really well. I packaged it really well. And I told David, I said, it's probably like going to be a pain because the way I packaged it.
Right.
But, I had like the most mint copy, which was for Danny. And then the other ones were for my brother and my best friend.
And then I was like, hey, I don't see anything here. And you're like, wow.
I held this for a year.
Yeah, that was nuts. Like when everything just started crashing and burning and we were in California and we had this whole tour planned and like all these appearances and had to cancel everything. It was so heartbreaking.
Yeah, but I remember you guys did a video too when you guys had to cancel
everything.
With all three of you guys. And I think you guys were like in an SUV or something. You guys made it like apologizing for like the cancellation and stuff. But it's understandable. The pandemic's been crazy.
Crazy. It is what it is. We're all here.
All right. Yes. If you could sign the first Playboy to Danny, like the best copy, whatever.
Okay. So I'm going to do the best one to Danny, right?
Yeah. Since it's for me.
This one's the nicest one.
Okay.
Okay, what color would you like it?
Whatever color you think it looks good.
Okay. I like the black. Oh, you know what? The blue would look nice. It's got blue on it. Okay.
So, quick question.
Yes.
So, obviously, you went with, like, the Diva Search when you came into the wrestling business. And I know that you always wanted to kind of be in the entertainment business. Was there anything in particular that drove you to wrestling, or was it just like an opportunity that you saw there that you thought that you can exceed in?
When I first moved to LA, there was a manager that managed Chyna and Stacy Keibler.
Okay.
And Tori Wilson. And I remember like talking to him about what it was like to be a diva. Mm-hmm. And I just thought, man, that just sounds like the perfect job for me, because it's like I was a dancer and I would open up for bands at bike rallies. So I loved like the rough and tumble crowd, passionate people that loved, something like that. And I'm aggressive by nature. So fighting anything like that is something I would like. And at the time, he said, you're just too small. I don't think that you fit the bill for what they're looking for. And I'm like, when the Diva Search came along, then they were looking for that smaller, more model type of a thing. But, I went into that contest and I was like, I had a feeling about it. I wanted to know everything about it. I wanted to understand the culture, psychology, just the lifestyle, and I just loved it. So, I was drawn to all the parts. I mean, there's really not any part of wrestling that I don't love. No, even travel,
No, you could tell that you love what you do. But I was just always wondering, I knew you wanted to be in the entertainment business. I was just kind of wondering whether, like, part of you that just loved wrestling as a kid, or just an opportunity that just came by.
Yeah, I think that it was a little bit of both. I already had like a passion for it, as far as like, it sounded like something I would love. And I'm not as much of with any sport, really, I'm not as much of a watcher as I am a doer. So like, I see something and I want to do it. I don't necessarily want to watch it as much. I love the entertainment value of it, but it's more that I wanted to get in and do it. I wanted to physically hit somebody.
And that's the perfect place to do it, right?
Yes, exactly.
All right.
Okay, so I'm going to show you this guy.
Awesome. Awesome.
Yay.
And then the next one is going to be to my brother, Antonio.
Okay.
He's a big fan of yours. He's been kind of going through a lot of like medical health issues and stuff. So okay. if you just want to make it to Antonio, maybe something like an inspirational quote or something.
Yes.
Of your choosing. That'll be awesome.
Tony.
Yeah, that's fine.
Was that what you wanted, Tony?
Antonio.
Antonio, how do you spell that?
A N T O N I O.
Okay.
Oh, awesome. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. And the last one, just make it out to my friend Jeff.
Jeff.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything special for him?
No, just to Jeff, and just you sign it. That's fine.
Sure.
And I also got the collage 8x10 as well.
Okay. Let's see here. And is this one to you?
Yeah, okay. If you can make it to Danny.
Sure.
It was so awesome just talking to you right now and meeting you. Hopefully all the stuff starts opening up again where I can actually meet you in person at one of the conventions or something.
Right. But even so, it's like, this is pretty cool.
No, it is. It is.
For you sure. know? And yes, in person will be exciting again one day.
All right. Awesome. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I don't want to take up too much of your time because I know there's a bunch of people that want to get on, but thank you again for taking the time to do this and really appreciate it. I can't wait to meet you.
Good luck.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Danny.
All right, see you later, Rocky.
See you, Danny. Appreciate it, buddy.
Do you want me to, like, because this is like a little pile of stuff. Mm-hmm. How do you want me to make it easier for you guys to keep it all together?
I think you're doing good.
Okay, even if I just stack them, but what if you can't read my writing?
It'll be all right. Okay. We know what everybody gets. I know what you're saying. It could be confusing. You can...
No, I just... want to make it easier on you guys.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Okay.
Worst case scenario, we can go back and watch the video.
Totally.
And there's like, yep, there's Danny stuff.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. All right, we got Angel coming in next. And Angel got the tape. We'll call it the tape. Got this one.
Photo.
And he got one of these as well.
Cool.
Welcome, Angel.
All right.
Angel! Christy,
what's going on, girl?
Oh, my gosh. I get to meet you.
I know. Oh, my God. You know, okay. So before I get started,
yes.
Rocky, David, thank you so much for putting this together.
Right.
Christy, thank you for taking the time out to do this for us. We truly appreciate it.
I love it. I'm so happy.
A lot of people know me as the ultimate Christy Hemme fan. And when I say that, I don't mean it lightly. I literally have followed your career from the time that you joined the Diva Search through WWE, through TNA. I even been to two of your shows with your band.
Aww.
So I've literally, every time there's been a signing on here, virtually. I've been a part of it. There's a bunch of stuff that, you know, I will never, never leave my possession because you are my absolute favorite, and I can't thank you enough for doing this.
And isn't this so cool that finally now I get to talk to you instead of just talking to the camera?
It's honestly the best concept I've ever seen because, you know, most of the time you're just, you know, they're reading comments to you instead of just being, you know, face to face like we are now. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So this is tremendous. And when I heard about you being a part of this, I was ready to go. I was full ahead. I was in heaven, ready to go, full blown, you know. But yeah, I have to ask you, like, a lot of people are asking about, you know, your wrestling stuff, but do you miss the band thing as well?
I would say that it's a really great part of my past, but I wouldn't want to go do the band thing again. Not that I didn't love it, but like now I'm in a totally different phase of life. And when I look back on all my different phases, like when I was in wrestling, when I was, you know, in the band, when I was working behind the scene, like all the different phases, I've really loved every single one. So I love looking back on the memories. I don't miss it in a way that I'd want to like now go do that right now, you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, I follow you on your socials, and I've got to say some of the videos that I see with you and your children are some of the cutest things that I've seen in the world.
Aww. And
I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy for you that you've found this happiness outside of wrestling.
Yes.
And outside of doing all this traveling and stuff like that. And I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy for your family.
Thank you.
And I have to know out of everything that you've done, is there an accomplishment out of everything that you've done, all the places you've traveled, all the matches and everything that you've done, is there something that sticks out to you as probably your favorite thing of all time?
Well, if you're talking about my favorite thing of all time, it would be my family.
Well, yes, of course.
Just because I'm like, it's really sweet. I've been so career focused for so long and not really put any energy into creating a family and doing all that it feels like such a blessing and like a really sweet prize for working so hard. And then as far as like in my career, my favorite thing was when I moved behind the scenes and started helping the girls and doing stuff for the girls, writing for the show, developing characters, because as much as I loved my own career and building my own brand, as you would say, I love doing it for other people even more. Like I really, really enjoyed working for them.
Wow.
So that would be my career highlight and then my personal highlight.
This is absolutely amazing. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Like I said, I can't, I'm almost in a shock because like I've always wanted to meet you and to be able to talk to you. And
I'm seen so happy that you're so happy.
Well, see, that makes me happy. So, like I said, I don't want to be one of those people that take all your time. Like I said, I could stare and talk to you and look at you for hours on end. But I appreciate the time. And I believe I got two of the 8x10s, I believe.
You got the photo.
Okay.
Do you want me to just make it to you with a little sweet note?
If you want, I forget, honestly, David might know what I put, what I asked for the inscription, but
I'll
do believe.
I'll tell you what you wanted.
All right, let's do it. Let's do two, my boo angel.
Yep.
And then XOXO and then signed.
The only thing that you didn't include that you wanted on that was you had love your feisty redhead.
I am a feisty redhead.
That's right. Thank you, David. I forgot about that.
Don't miss out.
This is awesome. This is awesome. I'm starstruck.
Okay, here's this one.
Perfect. That is perfect.
Yay. Perfect. And then the other one, this one doesn't have as much room to write on it.
Yeah, that one I'm completely fine with, you know, just picking a color that pops and, you know, two angel and then
hey, that Christy, one you can
put. Yeah.
Try blue on that one.
Okay.
Oh, blue one. That'd be blue nice. Contrast. I didn't think of that, Rocky.
Yeah, that'll look good with that. This guy. Cool.
That is amazing. That is amazing.
Awesome. Yeah, I like Christy, the blue better.
That came out really good, Rocky. That was amazing. But good Christy, call, I don't want to take everyone's time frame. Like I said, it was such an honor to be able to speak to you. Thank you. From the bottom, not just from me, but everybody else that's going to be a part of it today. Thank you so much for taking this time out for the fans and being a part of this, and good luck to everything else in your future endeavors with everything from your family to your career to everything. I support you 100%.
Thank you, Angel. And when you popped in, I have to say just a few things. When you popped in, not only are you like, you're like a bright ray of sunshine, just energy wise, you are such a delight.
But I also knew
exactly who you were. So that's so cute. See, now I can put a face to the name.
Well, like, thank you, Christy. I try to be the life of the party sometimes.
Yes, you
well,
are.
Christy, thank you. Thank you so much, Rocky. Rocky, David, thank you guys so much. Christy, take care of yourself and God bless.
God bless to you too.
See you, Angel.
See ya.
Aw, he's so cute.
Good times. Yeah, I just thought the blue might be a little bit better.
Yeah, it looks better because it pops.
Better contrast, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Real quick,
yeah.
One of your cards. I think it was the same one. Let me show you. This one here.
Yes. Yep.
Can we get one of those signed to Danny?
Totally. I've got a bunch of those, actually.
Soccer.
Who knew? For a girl that doesn't play soccer.
You look good holding the soccer ball.
I'm just holding the soccer ball. Cool.
There it is.
There it be.
Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect.
Wonderful.
All right, we got Robert coming in next. Robert bought your colorful TNA outfit.
Oh, yes. Yep.
And then he got the Playboy 8x10.
Cool.
So we're bringing in Robert. What's up, Robert?
Hello.
Christy, how are you doing?
Hi, Robert. I'm good. How are you?
Good. The Mad Hatter in the building. I couldn't pass it up on that one. I saw that and went, oh, I remember that. And when that was an option, I went, oh, that's a winner. How's it going? How are you?
I'm really good. Thank you. You know what I'm going to do for you, too? I'm going to look and see. I thought I had an 8x10 of that.
No, that would be awesome.
So I'm going to go through my stuff and see if I can throw an 8x10 into that little mix.
Anything else is appreciated. I do appreciate that.
Yeah.
Coming here from sunny Buffalo, New York. Where, I guess I'll ask, have you been to Buffalo, New York before?
I have definitely been to Buffalo.
Oh man, what was the go-to party scene at that point? Or any good places that you went to?
Oh man. I mean, I was more traveling to arenas. Mm-hmm. So it was kind of party on the road. I don't necessarily remember exactly where.
No, that's fair. I mean, at the end of the day, all we have is we have really good food, wings, and roast beef. And we have a football team that no matter how many times we lose, everybody still loves them. So
yes,
that's really about it. A question, though. So when you were announcing, one of my favorite announcers, I got to ask, was there a special TNA event, pay-per-view, or just regular Impact that was your favorite one that you announced?
I remember when Kurt Angle first came into the company. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, and he was, I don't think I was announcing at the time, though. I just remember being a part of the show and it being so magical at that time. I remember announcing Sting, and that one, I mean, like, there were certain people where it was just like, I felt like it was a part of history.
That's crazy.
And I was like, how am I announcing this person? You know,
I know, that's wild.
It feels so much bigger than me, like Hulk Hogan, you know, just, stuff like that, where I was like, this is really surreal because these are people that I really like idolize. Those are the ones that kind of jumped into my mind.
Yeah. Oh, 100%. Again, huge fan of your work, both companies. And again, I just want to say thank you for, taking the time to do this here. I know the Asylum guys, they've been so awesome with booking everybody. And then, when I finally went back on the website and I go, oh, not only it, I go, the Mad Hatter outfit's being offered and you're available for meet and greet.
Yeah.
So just so happy again. Again, thank you just for doing the show. I really appreciate it.
Or do you want me to sign it?
Yeah, sure. Definitely. Yeah.
Do you want it to just be, let's see if I've got it right here. Hold on. Da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da. There it is. Here it is.
Mad Hatter.
Do you want it just signed, or do you want your name on it?
You could put TNA Warren Halloween, yep. 2013.
Okay. This was a fun one.
Yep. Oh, yeah. I still remember that.
I loved it. Okay. So.
There we go. That's so awesome. Again, thank you so much.
Of course. And you, and I will search for that for you. So I'm going to set this aside so I remember.
Okay. Again, that would be so awesome.
Yeah.
And then I think I had one 8x10 as well.
Okay, which one?
It was the Playboy one.
The Playboy. Oh, that's right. That's right. And do you want this made to you?
Yep, to Robert. That'd be sweet.
Cool.
So awesome. Again.
Yay.
Thank you very much for your time. Thanks for
thank you
coming on the show again, Rocky, David, both Knicks. Again, love you guys to death, and can't wait for
love you, man. Appreciate aww you coming.
Thank you, guys.
Bye. He was awesome.
Awesome.
I love it. I love when people are just like so excited.
Makes everything all warm and fuzzy.
It does make it warm and fuzzy. It makes it feel like they're getting to do something fun during these crazy times. And that's why I like entertainment.
And also, I mean, some of our guests, you know, after being in the business so long, they're so beat up and it's kind of rough for them to travel.
Yes.
So to be able to do this from their kitchen,
is their crazy living room, right?
It's a godsend for some of them.
Yeah. That is so true.
So we got Rod coming in next. I see his ceiling fan. Rod, you hear me? There you go. Center up there, buddy. I think I'm going to tell you, he got the... Rod, you got that one, didn't you, buddy? Yeah.
Cool.
How are you, Christy?
Hi!
How you doing, Rod?
I'm doing great.
Nice to meet you.
Were you out on the links today?
No, because that's my brother. Mikhail Poygov.
You're just there to heckle him, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, enjoy your time, buddy.
Thank you. How are you, Christy?
Hi, Rod.
Nice to meet you, my friend.
So nice to meet you. Where are you?
I'm in Illinois.
Okay. I love that people are just all over and I'm getting to travel the country right now.
Right. Yep.
I'm in Illinois.
What's that?
I'm basically in Illinois right now.
Okay, cool. Cool. Like it. Because you know Terry, right? Terry Reynolds?
Say it again?
Because you know Terry Reynolds, right?
Oh, yes. Yes, yes.
Yeah. Because I work with her. I'm her head moderator. She does a Twitch stream, and I'm her head moderator for her.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Because I'm in a wheelchair, by the way, so. I don't know if you can tell by me sitting here or not.
Did you what?
That I'm in a wheelchair.
I cannot tell.
Okay, well, thanks. I'm glad. Anyway, I have one question for you, though.
Sure.
In your entire career, if you could have one do-over, what would your do-over be?
WrestleMania.
Okay.
I was so green when I did that match. It was like one of my first matches ever, and it was on the biggest stage of them all. Right. And it was amazing, and I had the best of the best. But it'd be so fun to do it again.
Which WrestleMania was that, by the way?
21.
Oh, 21, okay.
Where are they at now? 36?
Yeah, 36 or 37.
They're at 37, wow.
Yeah.
That dates me.
Yeah. All right. If you wouldn't mind signing that to Rod the Mod, I would appreciate
it. Sure. Rod the Mod.
Yep.
I will do.
And you can just write whatever you want on it.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Cool.
Oh, that's awesome. Thank you, hon.
You're so welcome.
All right. Well, listen, I won't take your time. I know there's a lot of other people getting in. And Rocky, thank you for accommodating me today, buddy.
Hey, anytime. You know I love you.
All right. You guys take care and have a great day. Enjoy the rest of the time. All right, Rocky, as always, it's good doing business with you, buddy.
Yes, sir, bud. I'll talk to you later.
You certainly will. Thank you, Christy.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good old Rod.
Aw, does he do all of them?
I would say that he's becoming a regular. How about that? He started with Terry, and he's been jumping in ever since. So he's...
See, that's what happens when you guys start doing these guys. It's like you get your... group of people, right?
Yeah, we try to treat everybody special, and we try to give them that experience. And
yeah,
when they walk away from their meet and greet, we want them to feel excited, feel that they got their money's worth. So that's
our goal. Be like, hey, I want to do that again.
Yeah, we want to make it affordable and worth everybody's while, so they keep coming back.
I love it.
All right. Well, I was gonna bring in Marco, but it looks like he's
MIA.
Let's see who we got next.
So do they just kind of wait in a queue?
Yeah, we have a backstage area that holds, I think, 10. So everybody's watching from there. They can see us. I can see them. They can't necessarily... I can't hear them, but I can see them.
Right.
So I think Marco finally popped back in. There he is. Here comes Marco.
Hi.
Hi, Christy.
Hi, Marco.
Very nice to meet you for the first time.
Very nice to meet you. Where are you in a classroom?
No, I'm actually on my lunch break at work.
Oh, okay.
And I'm not home, so I asked the guys if they were nice enough to let me talk to you on my lunch break because I'm not home. So
that is so nice.
Yes, they're really good people. So
where do you work?
I'm at Walmart.
Yeah. So what are the stars?
Those are the that's like one of our walls for like the employees here.
Oh, okay.
Good things and stuff. Yeah. But I followed your career ever since your Diva Search days, so at the very beginning.
Thank you.
And your stuff in TNA was really, really good.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Yeah, I enjoyed my time.
Did either company ever offer you a women's title run by chance?
I was on my women's title run when I was with Kong.
Right.
And then I got injured. And that was the end of my in-ring career. I have 3 herniated discs in my neck that sit on my spine. So I will not be wrestling ever again.
Well, I don't blame you.
Yeah.
I really don't blame you.
Yeah.
But
and they say wrestling's fake.
Well, you look great. It looks like you could have done another 10 years if it was in you. But
aw, thank you.
But it was really, hopefully I get to meet you in person one day.
One day.
Yes. After all this crap is over with.
What city are you in?
I'm in Illinois. So it's a little town in Illinois called Olympia Fields.
Olympia Fields. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I live like 5 minutes from my work. So it's not too far. So
that's awesome. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Convenient.
Yes. It was just really nice to meet you. So I had a couple things I ordered from you. I had a Playboy and an 8x10.
Okay. There's the 8x10. Who do you want me to make the 8x10 to? Marco. Okay.
Yes. And then if you could put, because I loved you guys in TNA, the Rock and Raven faction.
Yeah, of course.
And the year that you guys started. And then whatever else you want to put.
And the year that I started.
The year that the Rock and Raven faction was born. I think it was.
Yeah, so I guess that would have been.
07?
That sounds about right. It's either 06 or 07.
Well, you could put 06-07. So we, you know.
2007.
Thank you. So okay. Right. And then like. Rock and Rave Infection, and then whatever you want to say, and then sign it for me, like best wishes or thanks for being a fan, or
yes,
because I am Christy.
You're so sweet.
Wow,
thank you.
I mean, I've been a fan since 1984. Professional wrestling is my life, so that's the other thing I love.
It's love.
So let me see.
There we go.
Oh, perfect. Perfect. And then if you sign the magazine, mm-hmm. you could just make it to me.
So let's then, okay. So in my stack here, which sticky would be on yours?
It would be in one of the do you have it? It's either gonna be one of yours or one that I sent that says for sale unless we already labeled it.
Okay. I need to go grab my little stack
too. Yeah, it's probably going to be one of yours then. That's okay. Fine.
Oh, I have one for sale.
That you can use that I'll one. Use That'll one. Work.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and then for the next one, I'll get my little stash.
Okay.
And this one to Marco.
Right.
Okay.
And then you can put whatever you want, Christy, because it doesn't matter. Just a nice message for me, and then sign it for me.
Sure. Okay. There we go.
Awesome. Thank you so much, dear.
Thank you so much.
Very nice to meet you, like I said, and hopefully I'll get to meet you in person one of these days at a Comic-Con or a convention when all this is over. But it's nice just to chat with you like this, too.
It's going to happen.
And mm-hmm. I wish you all the best in the future, your family and everything, and everybody, you know, bless everybody. And we'll see you soon, hopefully.
Thank you, Marco.
Okay. Thank you, Rocky. I appreciate you.
No problem, bud. We'll see you later.
Right, take care, guys. Bye-bye.
You too. All right. Moving right along.
Moving along.
We got Steve Martinez coming in. And he got one of your Playboys as well, so you might as well go ahead and grab your stack.
Okay, I'll be back.
Well, no. I think that one might be labeled to Steve, but if she gets her stack, perfect. Yeah.
Yeah, she can have it.
Yeah, because we'll probably sell them during while the show's going. So, trust me, they're all in the same condition, so it really doesn't matter. All the ones I sent in were brand new.
Minty.
Yeah. So.
Cheers, everyone.
Yeah. Unsweetened iced tea. Cheers.
Java. Got to have the Java. Then we're going to work on a Mountain Dew next.
Well, at least this unsweetened has caffeine in it. So there you go. There's that.
Good. And everybody that's watching, if you're wanting to jump in with Christy, message Dave or any of the admin of the Asylum, or even jump on our website.
I know Steve's a collector as well. Yeah. She has a TNA outfit, Steve, that's actually really well priced. If you want her to hold it up,
which one?
Let us know. It's her red dress she wore in TNA in the ring. I know he likes to collect stuff, so and he also likes to give us his paycheck. So
thanks, Steve. You're the best. I see Becky's backstage, but she's been frozen for like
she'll probably minutes. Come back. It happens sometimes to her camera. She'll be back. We see a Stu and Steve. Steve, you're the other Steve. You're after this Steve, just so you know. I'm glad you finally got it working. So,
where'd Martinez go?
We just lost him. Edward, I PM'd you. He'll be right back, I think. He got so excited over that dress, he clicked the wrong button. Edward Paul, I am PMing you now. Oh, Rick is back. I think StreamYard's been acting up a little bit. I've been noticing a lot of people leaving and coming. I wonder if there's an issue going on that we aren't aware of at this moment.
I don't know. I haven't seen anything pop up.
Yes, I do, Rod. We do.
Christy is getting her stack of magazines. She'll be with us in just a moment. And she might be getting a sandwich. Who knows?
There's Steve. See, Steve went to go re-up his checking account.
Yeah, he hit the limit higher.
To make sure he can afford the...
What do you mean it's only $500? You got to make that $1,000.
It's actually nowhere near that price. Her prices are really good.
We're all kidding, Steve. We appreciate you.
We love you, Steve.
Yeah, we appreciate you immensely.
Okay, I got a little stack.
I figured you were making a sandwich or something.
And totally making a sandwich. And then I made sure that they're good looking ones.
Okay. I thought there'd be a lot of kids running around. It's nice that you have a little quiet time.
You know what? They're napping right now.
And we better hurry.
Yeah.
You hear one
they're
get
fine
up.
Though. My husband's with them. So.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
One of them gets up. It's going to be fun time.
Yeah. I got
there time. Should be one labeled Steve, though, there okay. on the table, I believe.
One label Steve.
I think there was.
Yeah. If not, no biggie. We'll use
I got Zach, Doug.
Yep.
Don. No
yep. Steve. Okay, we'll just use.
Oh, you know what? That was that crunched one. I had like a crunched paper that wasn't attached to anything.
At the end, it'll all add up to the same amount. You can use one of yours. That'll work.
Okay. Okay, so I'll do one of these guys.
For Steve. Yep. Perfect.
Okay.
There he is.
Hi.
Hi, Christy. How you doing?
Hi, Steve. Hey, I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I ran home from work for this. So.
Oh, where's work?
I work in Aurora, Illinois. I'm from Chicago, so I work for DHL Supply Chain.
Cool. I like your shirt.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Got these from the pro wrestling tee store in Chicago.
I love pro wrestling tees.
Been wanting to meet you for many years now, and just a big fan of everything you've done with TNA, especially. I was a big TNA fan, especially I saw you with the Diva Search. But going back, I also knew that you played for the Chicago Bliss, right?
I did.
Yeah, I had season tickets.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah, I used to go to the games because I was in the security business when I got out of service, and they gave me season tickets because I did a couple of the security for the autograph signings that the girls used to do.
Wow, that's awesome.
But yeah, it was I remember you from back then. I think you were the quarterback, right?
I was quarterback and front lineman for the defense.
So tell me about your days playing in LFL, as they call it now.
I loved it. I had so much fun because a lot of my girlfriends were playing. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, the girls just had so much fun. They were a pretty aggressive bunch, which I'm down with that.
Yeah.
We just had a blast. It was a lot of fun. It's just playing with your girlfriends, really, on TV.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of people thought that it was kind of, you know, fake, but I've been to the games.
Oh, no.
Those girls hit hard.
They were so serious. I loved it because they were so serious. I mean, that's like with mm-hmm. wrestling too. I like an aggressive girl, and everyone mm-hmm. that played was totally into it.
Now, why didn't you stay with them?
I believe the next year they didn't play. I don't think they did it again. Okay. I mean, they only did it for a couple years, right?
Yeah, I think it was like 2004 to 2006.
Yeah, so
they got a new.
I want to say I did the last year.
Okay. Yeah, because I think that was the year they're going to the championship bowl, and you guys lost
mm-hmm.
the semifinal game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, against New York, I think it was.
Yep.
But they have
an incredible memory.
Yeah, I do. I remember a lot of stuff. But they have a new team now called the Chicago Blitz. So.
Oh, okay. But are they still playing?
They haven't played since the lockdowns and, you know, everything's happened. So they were playing a few years ago. But there haven't been any games. But they're out there doing meet and greets and stuff still. But,
oh, wow.
Yeah, I haven't heard. They just started doing them. So
cool.
But, I just wanted to meet you, and it's an honor to meet you. And I'm a big fan, and I just like I said, I really appreciated anything. Like when I was, you know, watching TNA, and I'd be in the other room, I'd hear you starting the announcing, I'd run into the room and start.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, so, thank do you still watch me. Impact?
I do. I have to watch it. I don't have the Fight TV app or anything like that, so I just watch it online.
Mm-hmm.
And, like ODB, I'm a big fan of hers, and she just
love came her. Back
not too long ago. So, yeah, it was the whole, you know, Impact Divas, you know, division back when you guys were in it were great. Mm-hmm. Your whole thing with the fight against the Mafia, that I love that story.
Yeah, yeah. They did a lot of cool stuff back then.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of cool stuff. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, but thank you taking time out of your schedule to do this for me and for all of us here.
Mm-hmm.
And if you could sign the magazine, just make it out to Steve.
Sure.
And we could put anything you want on it. And do you have any of those cards left too?
I do.
You can sign one to me too. I'll square it up with Dave.
Yep. I'll show you this guy.
Perfect.
So there's that. And then do you know which one you want?
Anyone?
A couple of different ones.
Yeah, anyone's fine with me.
I'll show you a couple different ones, and then you can choose. So here's got red bikini, white bikini, kitty cat. I also have one where I'm holding a soccer ball.
Do the red bikini.
Red bikini. Red. That looks cute with the Playboy too, actually. Okay.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
So cute. Okay.
And once again, thank you. And, you know, just a big fan. And hopefully one day I'll get to meet you out.
It's going to happen for sure. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks, yeah, Rocky. Steve. All right. Bye.
Better get back to work. Get that wallet filled back up.
I got to work tomorrow. So
take care, buddy. All right. So we had a sale. Might as well take care of. Okay. Rod got one of your magazines.
Okay, one of the Playboys.
To Rod the Mod, and maybe put a special message on there for him.
Yes, to Rod the Mod.
And I believe Glenn got one of your red bikini cards as well.
Yes, okay. So this is Rod.
Beautiful.
Yay. And then.
That blue's been our go-to color, hasn't it?
You know what? That blue's looking good on just about all of it.
Yep.
And then the red bikini.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To Glenn, one N.
I mean, that matters. It's like when people put a K in front of my name. And it's like, that just doesn't even look right. Okay. Okay.
There you go, Glenn.
Glenn!
All right.
I just been putting these little guys in here so they don't get lost.
Dave, what did you want gold?
He just wanted to see if she had a gold color. If someone's going to buy another magazine.
I do.
Okay, cool. I'll let them know.
Cool deal.
I got gold.
So we got Steve coming in next. And I'll let him tell you what he got. Mm-hmm. What's up, Steve?
Steve!
Hi, Christy.
Oh, my gosh. Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Broke two fingers the other day.
What happened?
I was helping my plumber's neighbor. We share a well. And
yes.
The well cover is like about an 800 to 1,000 pound concrete, solid slab of concrete.
Yes.
And he let go before I was ready.
Oh.
Yeah.
So did you break them?
Yeah, they're both the middle finger and ring finger are both fractured.
Oy. That's not exciting.
No, I actually, believe it or not, survived COVID in October.
Oh, you got it and it was really bad?
I couldn't smell for 9 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah, and my mom, who's now 82, lives with me.
Yeah.
She got it, but she had completely different symptoms than I did.
What were hers?
She was falling asleep every time she sat down, and she lost her taste.
Wow.
I only lost my smell, and I never ran a fever or nothing.
How bizarre. I mean, it's just been so bizarre how everyone has totally different response.
Yeah, and I have a married couple that I work with. He tested positive for COVID with no symptoms.
Yeah.
His wife lost her smell and taste and tested negative.
Yeah.
So it's bizarre. One of those. Yeah.
I haven't seen you in so long.
The last time I saw you was I was front row at Impact in Indiana, PA.
That was a long time ago, Steve.
It was the week before you announced you were pregnant with your first child.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
I know. Yeah, I miss seeing you and talking to you at the shows and everything.
Yeah,
I wasn't getting good reception at my house, so I had to drive up on the hill from where I live to be able to get a good signal so I could chat with you a few minutes. Good.
I'm glad that you took the time and left then, because otherwise I would be so sad to sign a picture and not see your face.
I know. I just found out today you were doing this. I saw your tweet and I thought, I got to do this tonight and hopefully try to get on and see you for a minute.
Yeah. So it's so funny because I have not tweeted in forever. So going to my Twitter, I'm like, how do I even post something? I had to like figure it out again.
Yeah, I know. You're kind of busy with all the kids and everything. So.
I'm slightly busy, Steve.
Yeah, and I loved what you did for their birthday this year with all the Star Wars stuff.
Let me tell you, they're so obsessed. It is hilarious.
Because if there's one thing I love more than wrestling, it's Star Wars.
Yes. So my son, Hemme, he wears his Stormtrooper mask, like kind of on his head, and he holds his gun, his like little pew pew.
Yeah.
He all day long. He won't take his Stormtrooper mask off. He loves Stormtroopers.
Yeah, I loved it. And I don't know if you and Charlie have heard, but they're adding the 2 live-action Ewok movies to Disney Plus in like a week or two.
Wait, they're adding what?
2 live-action Ewok movies that aired back in the mid-80s.
No way.
And 2 seasons of an...
I haven't seen that.
Yeah, I actually have them on DVD. The first one's narrated by Burl Ives. And then the second one guest stars Wilfred Brimley from Cocoon and the Quaker Oats commercials.
Wow.
And then they're adding 2 seasons of the animated Ewoks cartoon as well.
Yeah, I'm a huge, we're all a huge fans.
Yeah, I keep up on Charlie's Facebook when he's posting the kids skiing and stuff.
Yes.
I shared a picture of my inflatable baby Yoda for Halloween and Christmas I found at Walmart.
Oh, yeah. Baby Yoda is all the rage around here.
Oh, yeah. Same with me. I love baby Yoda.
I love baby Yoda.
I haven't met anyone who doesn't.
No. I love that we all call him baby Yoda and he's not baby Yoda.
Yeah, as soon as I saw him, I'm like, that's a baby Yoda. And then that became the thing. And,
yeah.
You know, now everyone calls him that. And, you know, so, yeah, it's kind of cool, you know, that they're such big Star Wars fans. And I loved how you did all the food-themed Star Wars for their birthday this year.
So is your mom doing good, though?
Yeah, she recovered. After only a few days, she was better.
Good.
You know, and like with me, you know,
older people.
Yeah, that was my concern because she's had some bouts with atrial fibrillation, is diabetic, has a thick wall around her heart, which is inherited, which I have to go to the heart doctor to get checked up every so often, but I don't have any signs of it. So.
Have you been going to a lot of shows?
The last show I was at an AEW show in Pittsburgh. That was in 2019 when they were just starting to get out and everything.
Yeah.
So my buddy, he knows a promoter in Pittsburgh and they run indie shows in my area. They're hoping to do one in October.
Oh, okay.
Or November. So, because a lot of the wrestlers from there are getting a shot with AEW on Dark over the next few months. So.
Oh, yeah.
And some of them, like Allie, and he used to be Braxton Sutter in TNA.
Yep.
Pepper Parks.
I love them.
They wrestled in my hometown area once. And guys like DJ Z and Elias and Eric from the Viking Raiders. What was that?
Is he wrestling?
DJ.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's with NXT now for WWE.
Oh.
Yeah, he's known as Joaquin Wild now.
That's cute.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of cool to see all these guys right before they make it to TV and stuff.
Yeah.
you know, and I was thrilled last year right before the pandemic when I saw you, Amy, and Gil start your Kickstarter and everything, because I donated right
away. And then COVID killed us.
It kills everything.
Killed everything.
Yeah. So, yeah, I bought the 11 by 14 poster.
Oh, cool.
Because I have the other artwork posters I've seen of you over the years from Jason Beam and that's Scott. I can't remember his last name. Yeah, Scott Blair.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought, I'm going to have to add that to the collection.
You know what? This one's really cool. They did a great job with this. It looks...
Yeah, that was the first thing that popped up, and I thought, that's what I want.
What color did you want, Steve? Did you want a gold?
Do you want gold?
It doesn't matter what colors, as long as it... If you'll be able to see better what marker would work the best.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm actually sitting in my car up on the hill from my house.
Yeah.
My internet's just so bad anymore because all the trees, and you literally have to drive 3 miles downhill to get to my house, and then 3 miles up another hill to get away from my house. So it's like the internet's terrible.
Well, at least there's an option, thankfully, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I told Mom, I said, hey, I'm going to run up on the hill and try my internet connection up there. I'm trying to do a meet and greet with one of the wrestlers.
What does she think?
She said, okay.
Okay. Okay, here's this.
Oh, that's excellent.
I love it.
Can't wait to add it to my collection, get it framed and everything.
Yay. Well, I miss you, Steve. It's good to see your face.
I miss you, too. I hope to see you someday at a show in Pennsylvania again. And
yep.
I almost ended up in West Virginia at a show tonight, but my friend canceled, so worked out perfectly.
Good. I'm glad that
this was my first ever virtual signing since COVID started. So when I saw it was you, I knew I had to do it.
Well, and this is my first virtual where I can actually talk to the person. So I love it.
Yeah, I like it too. It's something different.
It is. Okay. Thank you, Rocky.
Thank you, Rocky.
No problem.
Okay.
Hey, take care, Steve. Christy.
You too. Bye, Steve.
Bye.
See you, buddy.
See ya.
I've known him for a very long time.
We got Becky coming in next. Becky also got one of these.
Cool. I love that print. It turned out really nice.
It did. It turned out really good. I can't pronounce. Can't pronounce her name.
Whose name?
That did the artwork. Dave, can you pronounce it? I want to say like.
No.
Stop.
Give me 1 second. I'll get it.
It's like a Yugoslavian.
Can you guys hear my kids?
Just a little bit. Oh. It's the calm before the storm. He's corralling.
We locked my door because the last time I was on a virtual, they climbed. There's like a fence. They climbed over the fence and like just burst in. It was hilarious.
Nothing will stop them.
I'm like, out of my room.
You'll start seeing the doorknob jiggling. And then
it'll fall
off. They took the screws out of it and they're looking through the hole.
You don't need your mother right now.
Here comes Becky. Mm. Hi, Beck.
Hello. Oh, gosh.
Hi.
I've been sitting backstage, and I just have been loving your reactions with everything. You're so sweet.
I'm just really enjoying this. I love being able to actually talk to you guys.
Yes, it's been so cool. Like, this has been the only way I've gotten to, like, actually meet some of you guys. Because I've never had the chance to like go to a show or go to like a live event or whatnot. So this is really
it's
cool.
Definitely there's a lot of benefits out of COVID's been hard, but there's also been benefits.
Oh, absolutely.
And this is a benefit.
Yeah. This is super cool.
Cause I'd imagine that virtual will probably stay because now people that maybe aren't able to go to a show are able to like meet us and talk and
you know.
Yeah.
It's been really cool just to be able to like actually get a chance to talk to someone you've been watching for years and whatnot. Yeah. And it's like, ah, you're real.
You're a human. Yes. So who else have you met?
The first one I did was ODB. Mm-hmm. David was nice enough to let me come in and say hi and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And I was like, ah!
And she's a good one to meet.
Oh, yes. Now she, because of her, I now try to find like a sippy sip to have during these things.
It just makes it more entertaining.
It was. Yeah. And then Victoria was the last one, which was super cool because she was one of the first ones I saw when I was starting to watch wrestling.
Yeah.
And now I see, like, with you, I remember you being an announcer in TNA, and I'm like, I missed your wrestling career, it seems like.
How old are you?
I'm 25 right now. I started watching in like 2006, 2007. So now I'm going to have to like, I'm going to have to like watch back and everything.
Yeah. I'm old school. I'm like way back.
Yeah. But that's the cool stuff too, though.
It is the cool stuff. All of it's the cool stuff. But I love the eras, the different eras.
Yeah. Words are hard. So I was wondering with like that, you know, because that group of knockouts was incredible.
Oh, yeah.
If you had any fun road stories or like any fun memories.
I mean, there's a lot I can't say because it involves people.
That's valid.
But honestly, you know what? We had the best locker room. We had so much fun. And we traveled together, just the whole world. But like, you know, imagine doing it with your best friends.
Yeah. And
just doing like life at that time. Because I didn't have kids. I was married later in my career. We just had nothing is necessarily popping in my mind as like a road story. I mean, we have a lot of stories, but.
Oh, yeah.
It's more the feeling of loving your locker room. And being close friends with them and just laughing at the stupidest shit. Like, I mean, the things that we laughed at, like, we just thought everything was hilarious. And if you're just together, it was just fun, all of it.
Oh,
yeah.
I feel that.
Yeah.
Like, laughing over the fun, silly stuff is honestly some of the best.
Yes. Yes. The meaningless stuff where you're like, it's just funny because you're just with your friends.
Oh, absolutely.
Where are you at?
I live about a half hour from Syracuse in like a little small town in New York. So
yes, I know
we're going to try this year to go to a first wrestling show or event or whatnot in Albany.
Okay, because they are running events there?
Yeah, there's one in October. There's a WrestleFest in October.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to try and check that out.
Yeah.
Finally branch out to live stuff.
Yeah. So they're having like it's like a big event or is it an actual wrestling show?
I think it's an event where you can get stuff signed and meet some of them.
Oh, cool.
It's very new to me.
Yeah. You got to go. I think you'll have fun.
Yeah. I've got tickets.
I'm going to meet everybody. Yeah, good, good, good.
So I don't want to take up too much more of your time. So for that 8x10, the art print.
So do you want me to make it to you?
Yes, please.
Okay.
I was so excited for this art print. I had one. I was working on one. And then I just... work happened and I never got a chance to finish it. I'm going to try and finish it tonight, though. So I can have it posted up.
I'm writing a special message for you.
Oh, thank you. You're so sweet.
There. Because you're getting brave, going to shows.
Heck yeah.
Yes, I think that's awesome.
Oh.
Go to your live show. Enjoy it.
So much.
Have so much fun.
Oh, thank you so much. And hopefully there will be one where I can see you in person too.
One day.
Yeah.
There's, you know what the next thing, like, this is awesome, but even better would be to meet you in person.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
thank you, Rocky and David.
Yeah, Becky. Thanks for coming in. Bye,
Becky. Oh, she's so cute.
She is a sweetheart.
She's really sweet. I'm happy she's going to go venture out. And
I'm anxious to go myself. We have all these people that we interact with on a daily basis with the shows, with, mm-hmm. you know, our group and everything. And to actually, you know, fist bump or shake a hand of a guy that you've been talking to for a while. And yeah, it'll be cool.
I mean, for me, when I like get to leave the house and go to them, it's like a vacation.
Oh, I know. Sure. Just get out and do something.
Total vacation.
You mean you don't take the kids with you?
Right? I'm like, even this right now, I'm stuck in my room and I love it.
I see you got your protein shake. I got a whole box of those over there. Shake. Yeah, my girls drink those all the time.
Well, so the last one that I did, I had like a protein bar.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I can't do that. I need my little shake. So I'm not chewing.
Some of those bars can be like compressed cardboard, I have to say.
Very much so. They're not the tastiest. But those shakes, I really love those protein shakes.
They're good. And they don't have to be refrigerated, so they're even better.
No. There you go.
So we got Stu coming in next. He got your collage.
Cool.
8x10.
Stu. Stewie. Hi,
finally.
Stu. Cool.
Digging the display in the back. Loving the belt. They look great.
Yeah.
Actual belts?
Yeah, the replica ones. Yeah, this is my new home office because you might have a bad accent, but I'm from the north of England, so we're still on lockdown and everything. So
yeah,
this is where I work for the time being, and I really don't want to go back to the office. I'm quite happy here. So
we love it. So where are you at? What city?
I'm in Kingston upon Hull, or Hull as it's generally known, in the north of England. So we're right over on the east coast.
Yeah.
Super
cool. I love your display. That looks awesome.
The pops, I don't know if you can see the pops at the top. They go the full, it's not a massive room, but they do go all the way around the top of the room.
Really cool.
It took ages to sort it out. But especially as well when we've got twin boys, so I know it's not quite on your level, but I appreciate the quiet room because this is
yes.
a quiet space away from,
you know what though, multiples are multiples. Like once you start getting into that, you're like at another level of parenting.
when you were saying before about having the gates, so when I heard you talking with Rocky earlier, like I don't know if yours are the same, but like we've got twin boys, and they definitely work together.
Mine, they work together. We're so outnumbered. We are so outnumbered. We were at a park the other day, and there was this 9-year-old-ish kid that was blocking two of them on the slide. And he thought he had it. You know, he's blocking 2 3-year-olds. And my other two boys that are like more aggressive saw him picking on them. And the other two come from the front and attacked him from the front. So he had like 4 3-year-olds attacking him at once. Because when the two saw that the other two were like coming in to save the day, that kid got out of there so fast. He was like so freaked out by the fact that there were 4 3-year-olds attacking him. And I couldn't stop laughing. I thought it was so funny.
It's awesome that they stick up for each other, though, as well.
Yeah, they got each other's back.
Yeah, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, my first trip overseas to watch any wrestling was SummerSlam 2004. Obviously,
okay.
bit of a disappointment that you guys weren't there in the arena, I guess, at the time, but...
Yeah.
One thing that I've always wondered was like the whole dodgeball thing. Was that like legit or
legit? Totally legit. And they were so pissed that we were whooping their butts.
Yeah, because like you guys only lost, was it Joy, I think, from the team?
Yeah.
And you absolutely smashed them. Right? It was
completely. Brilliant. Like, and they were so upset. And all the guys, you know, the wrestlers, they're like, I can't believe you let these models, these Diva Search contestants, beat you and show you up. They were so upset.
But then I suppose, like, well, quite a few years later, we went, got some friends who live a bit further west, and we went over to one of the TNA shows that you guys were over for. So we got to do like the meet and greet stuff, and it was you and JB came and said hello. So it was a quick hi and hello, but it's nice to actually get to talk to you this time.
Oh, fun. Yeah. We've had a blast. Yeah. Yeah. Many times with TNA.
What's the main sort of difference for you guys? Like, you know, coming like so far, I guess, like, I presume when you're in the States, it's just a quick sort of turnaround and maybe back home. Whereas when you're this far, it's got to be a bit different, surely.
Well, they set things up really well. You know, when we go over there, it's like, and because we're going so far, I think fans are so much more excited, which then makes us more excited. You know, just the energy, like when people are really excited to see you and like be a part of the show and, you know, do the whole thing. I think it just makes everybody that much more excited about the whole experience. And I think that everyone over there really shows their appreciation, and it's like this, you know, fun little dance that we're all doing, having fun, you know?
Yeah. No, I've been going for years and years. It was my gran that got me into watching the wrestling. She's 81 in a couple of months, and she still watches. So it's stuck with us, and my two boys.
And yells at the screen.
Yeah. I mean, the British wrestling thing is always well, the sport is the thing that's brought up, and it was always like the sort of stereotypical like nana at the front with a handbag, and she was one of them. So
yeah, but, wow.
Yeah, my two boys are 5 now, and they're 6 in October. But they're just starting to sort of take an interest in what Daddy watches on TV. So they're
okay. So then I have a parenting question for you, because mine are 3 right now, and yours are 5.
Yeah.
So does it get easier from 3?
I think you already know the answer to that question, Christy.
But I only have I have one that's older, but I don't know. Is it harder?
I've always said right from the beginning that, like, where you're at this particular point in time, whatever it is that seems like a hassle, in 6 months, a year, whatever, that won't be a hassle anymore. Something else just comes along and replaces it. It's not.
No, it's all a trade.
Yeah.
I'll just be trading for new things.
Here's one plate of rubbish that you've got now, and there's another one down the line, but then that one won't be a plate of rubbish by the time that's sorted out.
Yes.
Like, I mean, our guys they started school last September, in amongst all like the pandemic stuff and what have you. Yeah. And, like, I think I thought it was going to be horrendous, you know, horrendous struggle, kind of new sort of routine and way of life and everything for them, but like, these kids are resilient, man. They're absolutely loving it. When they actually get to go to school and we're not doing the homeschooling, they really, really love it. And it, like, that side of things has been easier, I think, once they got to the right age to get to school. So that's good. So I'm sorry.
So there's something good on the horizon.
yeah, absolutely. The picture, would you be able to sign just to Stu?
Totally, yes.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
I got you. I've enjoyed talking to you.
Thanks. Yeah, you too.
I'm like, wait, we got to sign something, right?
Yeah, it's got a fair old way to travel, that picture.
Yes. It's on its way.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, Stu.
Appreciate it. Take care. Thank you.
Yes. Good luck.
Cheers, Stu. Yeah, and you. Cheers, Rocky. Thanks very much.
Thanks so much, buddy. All right.
Parenting advice.
Yeah. You can't get enough of that.
No. Never.
It's always different.
Always. And there's always, he's right. It's just, you're just trading.
Yeah. Trading one bad for another.
Yes. It's so true. Because that's what it's been so far.
So we got Dean coming in next. Dean got the magazine. I think it's got the white cover. It might be mislabeled.
The magazine.
Not the Playboy. It's a different one.
Okay. I think it's the the Divas magazine.
Yep, that would be it.
Will verify live.
There you go.
That's why I wrote that, because when I mailed it in, I didn't know it was Dean's, and then he verified it was his.
Okay.
So we're good to go.
I love that you guys can just pop in and then
trivia,
just pop
like,
out.
Trivia questions, anything you need.
Yes.
And I'm over here
stumbling on anything. Just pop in and give me the answer, please.
When you were talking Star Wars, I'm over here fanboy, and I'm like, oh, Star Wars. You mean the Mandalorian?
I'm so obsessed with Mandalorian.
So I got to ask you this before we get Dean in here.
Okay.
How much did you lose your absolute mind?
Shit.
On the
I
last
lost
episode.
Shit.
I was.
We
at work.
All did. We all. I never thought that that's what was going to be it, and I was like, we were just. I screamed.
I can't believe they kept it under wraps.
I know.
Nobody knew it. Never like no.
Like that was the best possible thing. It was like so exciting. I couldn't even believe it. I was so excited.
And the storytelling and the way they pulled it off was just like
amazing.
I was sitting at work. It was towards the end of shift. I had a few minutes to kill. I thought, well, I'll just pop it on. Threw it on my phone there. And I was like,
oh no.
I got about, you know, when the buzzer went off, here comes the X-Wing. And I'm like, no, they're not. Really? Come on.
Yeah.
I just thought they don't have the brass to pull this off. No yeah. way, no how. And you know, I was getting teary-eyed. I was getting all misty.
I know. It was like so and the day that I watched it, I was at the grocery store before I went home to watch it with the family. And they were talking about it in line and everyone was getting pissed off.
Mm.
Like aisles down. Like they're like, "Don't spoil it."
Blah, 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 blah.
I'm like, "No!" So
all right, everybody out of the store. Everybody out of the store. Yes. We got to go home. Anyway, sorry. I didn't mean to.
I'm with you. I'm totally with you.
But I'm there. All right, Dean. From the Isle of Man. Dean Morgan.
Hi, Dean.
Hi, Christy. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You're from a place called the Isle of Man. You heard of it?
Say it again.
A place called the Isle of Man.
Where is the Isle of Man?
There's a little island in the middle of the Irish Sea.
Yes.
In between England and Ireland.
Oh, and it's really called the Isle of Man?
Isle of Man, yes.
That is so cool. And how big is it?
It's only 35 miles long and 12 miles wide.
And how many people live there?
85,000.
85,000? Okay, so that's a good amount. It's not...
Yeah, so the closest point would be Scotland is probably 17 miles the closest.
Okay.
So we're not actually part of the UK. We're part of the British Isles, but we're
right.
So you're actually the oldest government in the world, believe it
wow.
or not.
Wow. I want to visit there. Bucket list. Got to put it on my bucket list.
You'd be speaking to anyone else from the Isle of Man ever again. So
no.
Convention over Liverpool or something, or over that way sometime.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you gotten to see any wrestling shows live?
We get nothing over here. We have to travel to the UK to see anything. So,
do you do that at all?
I do, yeah. We go to a yearly convention. It's in Liverpool. Have you ever heard of it?
What is it called?
It's called For the Love of Wrestling.
In Liverpool?
In Liverpool every
yep.
year.
I believe so. It sounds very familiar to me. Yeah.
Yeah, so I speak to the guys sometimes. So that's something I can definitely put your name forward because...
Totally. And then I can hop over and see your little Isle of Man.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a 20-minute plane ride over 4 hours on the boat.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a little bit of a trek.
But no, I've not been to the, about a year and a half, I've not been to the UK, so.
Oh, because of COVID?
Yeah, well, we're in lockdown. I know England are as well at the minute, but mm-hmm. we actually can't leave the Isle of Man. We can't go anywhere. So
no one can leave?
Unless it's essential travel. But
wow.
This is how it gets here, you see. For 8 months of last year, we were actually the safest place in Britain from COVID.
Yeah, because you were so separated, right? Yeah,
but we're kind of sheltered, so, but it's when the people come in and from the Isle of Man, someone brings it here within a week or two, the spread is outrageous. So
wow.
We all the schools, and we have to stop work, everything just stops, and we're actually down to 7 cases a day at the minute now, but it was wow. about 70 or 80 a couple of weeks ago, so there's a big outbreak.
Yeah.
As you know, for 80,000 people, it's quite a lot, that.
Yeah.
But as soon as we get 2 weeks of no cases, that's when we can all get back to work again.
Yeah.
Not
so then you are in shutdown now and not able to go to work?
Yeah, I'm in the construction trade.
Are you enjoying your time off?
We're homeschooling the kids, so
yes,
you know yourself, it's not
yes,
it's easy to do.
It's so exciting.
Not for the kids. I've got a 5-year-old boy and then 2 older stepkids.
You have a 5-year-old boy and 2 older?
2 older stepkids, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's not easy, but
yeah. It's definitely not ideal.
I have a question about I loved it when you first come into wrestling. Do you regret not having a couple of storylines with some of the girls when you were there?
What you mean in WWE?
WWE before you left, was there a couple of feuds, a couple of stories you would have mm-hmm. liked with a couple of girls, your friends?
You know, I think that I would have loved to have a storyline with a lot of girls across the board and even across eras, but I certainly had a full, fulfilling time when I got to be in the ring up until my injury.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, there's so many girls that I would have loved to work that I just think are amazing.
Was that the main reason you left the company? Was it an injury or was it something you wanted to do?
So I stopped wrestling in the ring because I had a pretty major neck injury that I still deal with to this day. I wouldn't be able to wrestle unless I had some kind of surgery that fused things together, because I have 3 herniated discs and they sit on my spine. So it's one that you can't come back from unless you get surgery.
Right. Yeah, it's quite common in wrestling, yeah.
Very, unfortunately.
I only seen the WrestleMania 21 advert, when yep. Harry Belly was Kurt Angle.
That was fun.
I only came across that the other day for the first time. I don't know how I'd missed it.
Yeah.
They must have not aired in the UK here when WrestleMania was on and stuff, because it's only when I was looking on YouTube the other day, I thought it was hilarious. And
yeah.
Kurt, I've spoke to Kurt before, and he's one of the, you know, the nicest guys I've ever spoke to.
He's so. Such a sweet guy.
He's coming really on here guy. Well, so, yeah. He's there. Any stories about Kurt? You know,
Kurt and I worked in WWE together. We worked at Impact Wrestling together. We've always had many lovely conversations. He's a great father, a great husband, a great worker. And just, I would always pick his brain for advice just on so much, because he was so knowledgeable in the business and he loved helping. He always loved helping other people. So I was very grateful for my time with him.
Yeah, he's coming to the UK when the convention goes ahead again in Liverpool. So hopefully one day you can get there yourself.
Yeah, gosh, that'd be so exciting. Can I go now? I can't wait to travel again more. I'm definitely like a free spirit in my heart, and I want to just go adventure.
Yeah. It's the conventions. Do you do a lot of conventions? Do you do that sort of stuff in America a lot of the time?
When the conventions were going, I do maybe one every other month. No. I don't like to do too many because I'd like to go and like, it'd be really exciting, and
yeah.
You know, you don't want to water yourself down where you're doing them all the time and then the value isn't there.
Yeah. So on the magazine, if you want to write to Dean, Deep Search Champion 2004 or Deep Diva Search Winner or whatever you want to put.
Sure, okay. So Diva Search Winner 2004, right?
It's a correct year, isn't it?
I feel like somebody's going to pop on any second and tell me.
Yeah, I think that's right.
Rocky, David, somebody.
I was thinking I think it was 04, but I can't remember.
I'm fairly certain that's right.
Okay.
I just wanted to see if it would happen.
I was thinking about it. I was like, was it 4? Was it 5?
It was 2004.
Boom. Yay! Good, because I already wrote it.
let me lick that off there.
Thanks, guys.
Maria Canales was also in that one, and was great. Michelle McCool.
Yay. Yep, that is true.
Dean, thanks for stopping by from the Isle of Man.
Man, and I've got to make my way out there one day.
Yeah. I bet you it's beautiful.
Google the Isle of Man. Yeah. Lex Luger did it a couple of weeks ago, and he was fascinated.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. I spoke to him a few times on Twitter now, so.
That's cool. So cool.
Another great guy to speak to.
Yeah.
Great to meet you, Christy, anyway. I'll see you in the UK one day, and hopefully.
Yes. So great to meet you.
You too.
Thank you.
Have a great night. Cheers, Rocky.
See you, Dean.
Thank you.
I want to visit there. That sounds so fun.
Oh, I bet it's beautiful there.
I bet it's stunning.
Stunning, exactly.
Stunning.
So how you doing? How you holding up? You need a little break or anything? Or are you good? You can take a minute or two.
One minute.
Go ahead.
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll sell some stuff while we're sitting here.
Yay!
I see you, Steven. You're next. And then, Jeff, you're after Steven, just so you know. She's taking like 1 minute, Steven. She'll be right back. And I see you just fine. Your signal looks good. You guys can do it from your phones. Just make sure your signal's good.
Yeah, don't.
That's the only thing. If you're like out in like an area where there's no bars, it's going to be rough.
Yeah, it's going to be rough.
But Steven, you're moving fine. Go pick me up something since you're walking somewhere.
He's out in the parking lot. I have a hamburger, fries, large chocolate shake.
We do have some 8x10s that are available if anyone wants to order. It is $50 with meet and greet. $40 if you do not want to join us live. Here are your options. We have the collage.
Love it.
We have her busting through the front of her Playboy magazine.
Love it.
And we have what Rocky likes to call black tape.
Tape. That's a legend. And I think tape.
You only printed what? 10 of these? 12 of these?
Yeah. Very.
So there's
very
only limited. Like 5 left. So
very limited.
If you want it, grab it. This is $60. And it comes with a meet and greet, or it's also $60 without. These are one of those items where if you get it, you can take advantage of the meet and greet. If you don't, it's the same price.
No biggie.
We also have 2 Playboys left. Those are $75. She's got a bunch of cards if you want to see them. They are only $25 apiece. If you like collecting cards. She has some other 8x10s. Steven got one that will be signed off cam and after the show.
They're due to content.
Yeah, due to the content. But they are awesome pictures. And then we also have a ring worn, 2 ring worn attires that are actually very reasonably priced if anybody wants to grab one.
At the red dress and then what, the bikini?
The bikini top that she wore against Stacy Keibler.
Ah, I'm back.
She's back.
She's back. I kissed all my babes.
but they're like, where are you going?
They're like, wait, yeah. Mom, go
Can
back.
We go? Can we go?
Don't leave us with Daddy.
We'll sign stuff. Quick, yeah. Get the crayons.
Yeah. So with that bikini, I only have the top. I don't have the bottoms. I have no idea where the bottoms are, but I have the top.
Hey, it was against Stacey Keibler. It's an iconic moment.
It was
moment.
Against Stacey Keibler, and it was a lingerie pillow fight, and that won't happen again.
Nope. No, and you got to beat Nick Robinson down with pillows.
Totally.
How is Stacey? You don't see much of her lately.
No, she doesn't do anything with wrestling.
Which is odd.
Yeah, she's married and has kids. And
she in Cali, Florida? Where's she at?
I don't even know. I mean, I haven't talked to her in years.
She was always sweet.
Very sweet. Very sweet.
So we got Steven coming in next.
Steven.
And he got one of your, let's put it, off-camera pictures.
He also got a Playboy magazine as well.
Off and a magazine.
Camera.
Wink, wink.
Wink, wink.
And then we, like you said, he got one of your Playboys.
Cool. So you'll have to tell me. Hi.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good.
It's one
you?
Of yours.
I'm good. Thank
it's
you.
One of your stacks.
Yes. But then we got to figure out which one it is. Maybe
it could be any that's not labeled. One of your stacks that you just brought out. Because it wasn't one I mailed in. We sold one of yours.
One of the Playboys that I have.
Yes.
Then my off-camera photo.
We'll go over that. Yeah, we'll go over off-cam with that one. Yep.
Okay. Hey, Steven.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
Where are you?
I am in South Carolina.
Love South Carolina.
Right outside of Greenville.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been a longtime fan ever since you first entered camera on the WWE, and I've been following you ever since.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
You
were the one that made me forget about Trish, I guess I could say.
It's not a lot that could make anybody forget about Trish. She's pretty
I know,
amazing.
Right? I don't know. Maybe it was red hair. I don't know. But
I said, ha-ha.
Yeah.
Ha.
Great personality as well. So.
Thank you.
You're great
Thank
on TV.
You.
So how have you been?
I am very good. I am at home, which is nice. This is the first time I've done a virtual where I can actually sit and talk to people.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
I definitely miss this part of it.
Yeah.
It's been a weird year.
Exactly.
You know?
It has. Maybe once all this mess gets cleared up, you can start going around and meeting fans
yep.
again and
events
I love
again.
You.
Do you ever go to any events?
I do. I go to a lot of events actually.
What's your favorite?
My favorite probably for my wife and kids and I, there's a big event in Raleigh called Galaxy Con. It's a real big comic con.
I've never heard of that one. Galaxy Con?
Yeah, it used to be called SuperCon.
Oh.
They sold out year before last, I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's called GalaxyCon, and they're kind of wrestler heavy.
Yep.
So I've met Ric Flair, Charlotte Flair, Trish.
Cool.
Rey Mysterio. We've met a lot of wrestlers up there, so it's
That's
been
a pretty
cool.
good group you just named off.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty awesome.
How many kids do you have?
I have two. I have a boy and a girl.
And how old are they?
My daughter will be 14 this year and my son will be 12.
You're out of the toddler phase.
Yeah, they're growing up fast. I'm telling you, it's like a blink of an eye and before you know it, they're grown, you know?
It's so crazy, especially when you have kids. I feel like things go so much faster.
It does. It really does. A lot faster than before kids, for sure.
Yes. Especially since we can see it in, oh my gosh, you're 12. What? You were just 3.
Yeah. I can remember the day my daughter was born like it was yesterday. And that's been years ago, you know?
Same for me with my kids. It feels like not a long time ago, but it sure is a while ago now.
Exactly.
So do you want me to sign one of these Playboys to you?
Yes, ma'am. That'd be fine.
Okay. Me here. I'll make it to Steven or Steve?
Steven with a V.
Yep.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Awesome.
Awesome.
That was good. Thank you.
Hey. Okay. And I don't know which one. I don't know how they want to do the other photo. Did you know which one you wanted?
It was the one where you were in the tub.
In the tub. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that one?
Sorry, I clicked the wrong button.
Okay. The one where I was in the tub.
Yeah. That one. Grab it. Like I said, she can sign it, but due to restrictions, we have to keep those on the down low.
Yeah, I understand.
I imagine with all the guidelines and stuff that are getting watched.
It looks just like this.
Oh, yeah.
Is that perfect. The one?
That's the one.
Just sign the back of it.
Okay, so two. And this one you want two, Steven, as well?
Yeah, that's fine. Do you have maybe like a gold ink?
That yes, I do. Oh, yeah, that'll look nice. Totally nice. Yeah, you're going to like this. Sounds like you're at the beach.
I am. I actually just brought my kids to a skating rink. So
I went
to a cookout at my cousin's house, and I've been driving for the past hour. So I just got parked and tried to get on here and get this done since I wasn't driving anymore.
Yes.
But I'm not far from the beach. We'll be going in about 2 months.
To the beach?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I love the beach.
Yeah, it's nice. My wife and kids love it. I'm more of a mountains guy, but they love the beach.
Yeah, I'm a both. I like them both.
Yeah, I like the mountains, but I enjoy myself a lot when I'm at the beach. It's nice.
When you go to the mountains, what do?
I do a lot of everything. We like to, of course, for kids, you know, they like to do the arcades and the putt-putts and all those kind of go-karts, those kind of activities. And I like just riding through the mountains, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Roll the windows down and just enjoy the scenery.
And it's so beautiful.
It is, especially when the leaves start to change. So
that's
nice.
I love it. I used to live in California, and now I live in Oregon. Okay. And we get four seasons.
Yeah.
Where I wasn't used to that growing up. And I don't think I could ever go back now because I'm so obsessed with the fall leaves and the snow.
Yeah.
And
it's nice.
Seasons. Yeah.
Well, I don't want to hold you up because I'm sure you got more people waiting. I appreciate the opportunity, guys. And like I said, maybe when things get open back to normal, maybe I look forward to a chance to meet you in person.
That would be great. It's so nice to meet you.
Thank you. It's nice meeting you.
Yeah. Good luck.
Bye-bye.
Take care, Steve.
It totally sounded like the ocean.
It did. For real.
For reals.
All right. We got Jeff coming in next. What's going on, Jeff?
What's going on, Jeff?
Not much. How are you?
Hi, Jeff.
Hi, Jeff.
What's up?
We're getting a little reverb here.
If you got your speaker,
turned up, turn that one down.
Is that better?
Perfect.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Maybe a little bit more.
Oh, yeah.
That's as low as it'll go.
Perfect. We'll get by.
So Jeff Remington.
What's that?
Like the gun.
Yeah, pretty much. I hear that all the time.
His name is Remington.
I hear that all the time.
Someone has a cousin named Remington?
Huh?
Or just the gun?
Just the gun.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I went and met Sting today, so this is my second meet and greet today.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, he was at a car show today in Kansas City.
In person?
Yeah, it was actually live. He was there.
Wow.
So, the first one there?
It's the first one in, I don't know how long, what, a year and a half?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The first one that you did?
Yeah, because we have a car show here every year called the World Wheels. Okay. And so last year it got canceled because of the COVID.
What city are you in?
Kansas City, Missouri.
Super cool.
So how was it?
It was fun. Wasn't bad. Not as many people as usual, but that made it somewhat nicer.
Do they limit it more?
They did today.
Yeah. Which photo did you get?
I think it was the art.
The little
Yeah,
punch.
That one.
Oh, yeah. Do you want me to sign it to you?
Yeah, that's fine. That'll work.
To Jeff. Love the purple.
Thank you.
Yay.
Well, Jeff, thanks for stopping by, buddy.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Thank you, Jeff.
Tell Sting I said hi.
All
right.
See you, buddy.
See you.
It's always so funky when you can hear yourself.
Yeah, it's.
I'm like,
Everybody has a different setup.
Yeah, he might have had us on the computer. Because he probably had us on his computer, too.
Oh, I have you guys on my computer.
Well, if he had us on the
computer and his phone, too.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, I see.
I mean, your audio's on both.
Yeah.
All right. So we had a gentleman who could not get into StreamYard, but I promised him I would call him from Facebook Messenger. So we're going to, this is the first time I've ever done this. So this will be super weird. But he got it. One of the Playboys, I believe it's labeled to John.
Don Ramirez.
John.
No, John. J-O-N. Oh, John. Do I have one there labeled John?
Let me see. Doug and Zach. No, John.
Doug. Do we have it? Okay, Doug's is there. All right, well, we can use one of yours. That's fine.
Okay.
And then he got, let's see. He got one of your cards. You're in like a cat outfit.
Yep, I'm a kitty cat.
And then he got the collage 8x10. And I'm going to call him on Facebook Messenger and see if this works out for us.
Okay.
Usually he doesn't have any trouble.
No.
Maybe
well, he couldn't pop in here.
Right. If your internet's a little sketchy, your video is not going to work at all. Ah. It'll just be locked up and mess.
Uh-oh. Let's see.
We try to accommodate.
Yeah, I'm trying to, you know, he comes to every show. Here we go. All right, John. We're gonna get this done. Can you zoom Christy in? He doesn't need to see our ugly mugs.
What?
You're welcome. I even shaved.
What?
Hi! Yeah, Hank, get our ugly mugs off of here.
Hey. Can you see me?
Let's zoom her in.
Yes. Hey, Christy
Hemming,
I'm a big fan of yours.
Oh.
See if I can turn this up. There we go.
All right. I helped you win the Diva search contest.
Did you vote for me?
Yes, I remember you called me on my phone and I talked to you.
No way, during the Diva search?
Yes, I remember that.
So cool.
And I'm a big, big, big fan of yours.
Thank you so much for helping me get into the business.
You're welcome. Because you're my role model.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yes.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Did you see the items there?
I have items. Do you want me to sign them to you?
He also had, Christy, he had that WrestleMania 21 shirt too. That's right. Thank you, John.
Let her grab it. The card.
Yep, there's the card.
The Playboy.
He had an 8x10.
8x10 and the t-shirt.
And he had the WrestleMania 21 shirt because he had Lisa sign that too.
Super cool. Now you're gonna have to get everybody that was here at this time to sign it.
Let her know how you'd like the shirt, John.
It's to my big fan.
To my big fan. Love, Christy.
Yes. David, do you think we could get the next Diva to sign that?
Yeah. Yeah, no, we'll send it around the globe for you. We don't care.
I think that's an amazing idea.
So, do you mean?
Do you know who's next? Hulk Hogan's daughter.
So he wants Brooke to sign it next.
That's okay. So cool.
Yeah.
Can you see her right now, John, so she can hold it up for you? Okay.
Yep. Thank you, Christy.
There you go.
And can I follow you on Twitter if that's okay?
Absolutely, you can follow me on Twitter.
Okay, how do you want her to sign the magazine, John?
To my big fan, John Perry, like that.
Okay, and then spell John with just an N, J-O-N.
Okay.
And I was going by the artwork. Maybe I'll buy that tomorrow. Is it still for sale?
Yeah, we can have her sign you an artwork, John. That's fine.
Okay. It's a really cool piece, John. Okay,
here's your magazine, John.
Okay.
Sorry, we got a little lag. There we go. Got it.
Make sure this all.
How do you want her to sign the card? Just to John because it's small?
Yep.
Okay. To John.
This is like the first virtual per virtual I've done. There you go, John. There's the card.
And the artwork.
Yeah. Yep. And then, let's do your 8x10 first. How do you want the 8x10?
Yep.
You want that to...
Like that. To John.
To John. To John. Okay.
I'm going to use the blue.
Yep.
Yeah, you guys figured it out.
Yeah, do what you got to do.
Got to do what you got to do. Exactly.
There you go, John. There's your 8x10.
Okay.
And then what do you want on the art?
To John and Brandy.
Brandy with a Y or an I?
B-R-A-N-D-Y.
Okay.
To John and Brandy.
Yep. Do you ever watch AEW, Christy?
Yes, I do here and there. And I definitely catch the highlights.
You know who my friend is on there, right?
Who?
DMD, Dr. Britt Baker.
Oh, yeah? So do you like, is she nice to you or not nice?
Yeah, a little. Because Dr. Britt Baker's married to Adam Cole.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I wish you were at the Raw reunion last. I wish you were there.
Right?
That would Here's your good. Art, John.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And I'm going to go follow you on Twitter right now. Like,
yes, please do. Say, please do.
Stand back. There's a hurricane coming through.
All right, John. Well, we'll get that shirt over to Brooke for you, okay? And then we'll get that squared up for
That's
you.
That's so cool. You can get everyone to sign it then.
Yeah, and then who's next? Kelly Kelly.
Yeah, there you go. Well, thanks, John. Hopefully we can get this fixed for you for Brooke, okay?
Yes, thank you.
Thanks, John.
Thank you,
See
John.
Ya.
You're welcome. Thank you, Christy.
Bye.
Bye.
All right. We got that worked out.
Yay.
Rocky, that worked. You can come back in now, Rocky.
That was the first.
Yeah. First. Worked out, didn't it?
Yep.
All right, so we're going to do some people that unfortunately couldn't make it with us. So we call this part basically rapid fire.
Okay.
I kind of just list out what they had. We sign it and then we go from there.
Do you still do the hold up?
Yep.
Yeah. He'll zoom you in. We'll probably drop. You probably don't need to see our faces. So we'll probably just zoom you in.
Okay.
But.
All right. Here we go. First one is going to be the 8x10 Playboy.
Okay, this guy? Yep.
Yep. And we're going to make that to Randy.
What color?
Pink pop on that at all?
Which color?
Let me look
would
here.
Pink pop on that?
Pink,
I would go with the blue again just because the Playboy is in blue.
Yep, the blue does look nice.
Maybe right across your stomach.
To Randy, R-A-N-D-Y. And then just signed. There you go, Randy. Sorry you couldn't make it.
Sorry you couldn't make it.
Our next one is going to be the same 8x10, the Playboy. We're just going to sign it. No personalization.
Okay.
All right, there you go. This one's for Josh Blevins. Sorry you couldn't make it.
Yay.
Our next one will be the 8x10 collage. Rocky will plop that on the screen.
Okay.
And we're going to make this one to Michael.
To Michael.
There you go, Michael. Sorry you couldn't be with us. All right. You should have a Playboy to Doug.
To Doug. One that has a sticky note on it?
Yes, that's correct. Okay. I got to figure out a better way when I mail these in to put something different on it, because these sticky notes, they fall off.
Yeah, and no, even like when
they curl up. Whatever.
They curl up, and then when I'm like collecting everything,
yeah,
I use the sticky notes, but I use for some reason the I don't know mini why. Ones.
So you know minis. what would work actually, if you make sure it's in a sleeve and you put the sticky note in the sleeve.
Yeah, that's true.
But these little boogers here stick better than the big ones.
The little teenies. Why?
Okay, so Doug.
This one will be in light blue.
Okay.
We'll make it to Doug and then put a whatever inscription you'd like.
Okay.
There you go, Doug.
Oh. Hold on.
The little advertising card. Yeah. Well, I wonder if we mail that in if it still works.
Right?
All right. Okay. Next one will be an 8x10 Playboy cover.
Okay.
We're going to make this to Brian. It's Brian. And you're going to put Love, Christy. He lives in Denmark.
Denmark. Exotic.
There you go, Brian.
Yay.
So I'm going to ask, do I have a Playboy there as well, labeled to Dan?
Let's see here. I'm fairly certain I saw Dan. Oh, well, this is.
Yeah, it might have been. Yeah, there might be a Don one.
Be a Don Ramirez.
Okay, that's fine. We'll get to that momentarily.
I see a Zach Lanny.
Okay. Is there any other ones other than yours?
No, you used them.
Okay, so we'll use now one.
I have one of mine.
That's fine.
Let's see. We've got two empty guys.
Oh, okay. You can use one of the empty guys.
Okay. Okay. This one goes to...
This one will be to Dan. And then you can put whatever you'd like on it. There you go, Dan. Sorry you couldn't be with us.
Dan the man.
Right. Next one will be the 8x10 in the black tape.
Okay.
And we're going to make that to Kevin, and then he wants you to write Hemme powered.
I love it.
There we go.
Looks good.
All right. The next one will be that magazine labeled to Zach.
Okay. Zach Attack.
And then we're going to write to Zach, Z-A-C-H. And then any inscription you'd like. A lot of these people are easy peasy tonight.
I love easy peasy. I also don't mind if they have something they want said.
There you go, Zach.
Yay.
Our next one will be an 8x10 Playboy.
Okay.
We're going to make that one to Michael as well.
Michael.
Yeah, thought. There you go. All right, and we had Rick pop in, so we'll go ahead and bring him in. He had your 8x10 in the tape.
Okay.
I'm going to drop out, and we'll bring Rick in. Hey, Rick, how's it going?
Hi, Rick.
Hi. Hi, Christy.
How are you?
How are you? I'm doing good.
Good.
Bad connection everywhere. Sorry.
It looks like a lovely evening, day, time. I don't know what time it is there, but it looks lovely out.
Yeah, it's beautiful weather here.
Where are you?
El Paso, Texas.
Oh, I love it there.
Yeah, beautiful weather right now.
It is beautiful.
Yeah. I was actually getting ready for doing a reservation for dinner. It's my birthday tomorrow.
Happy birthday!
Thank you. Yeah, so I was trying to get that done, and then I was trying to connect, but for some reason it wasn't getting. But I'm glad I got to connect and got to get to talk to you real quick.
It's working beautifully.
I had a couple of questions for you, Christy. I was wondering, are you going to be doing Comic-Cons once hopefully we go back to normal here pretty soon?
You know, once it goes back to normal, if there's one that fits into my schedule, I'll definitely be doing it. I would love to meet you in person.
Awesome. Yeah, I think my friend has met you at the Austin Comic-Con. I know you've
done that one.
The Austin Comic-Con? Austin, Texas?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's a good one. That one's very busy.
Hopefully I get to meet you one day. Yeah. Yeah, I think I forgot which 8x10 I got, actually. I don't remember.
You got a collage. Or that one?
Yeah, I think I got, that one.
The tape one?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. You know where I got that outfit?
No.
Walgreens in the tape aisle.
Oh, wow. Wow.
I said, hey, that looks like a cool outfit.
Wow.
Who should I make this to?
If you could do just happy birthday, Rick, and then you can any inscription you want.
I love it, yes.
And then, whatever marker you think will show up.
Birthdays are so exciting.
Yes. Especially this one, since I didn't get to celebrate last year.
Yeah. And everybody should get to celebrate their birthday.
Yes. Oh, that's awesome, Christy. Thank you so much.
Yay. You're so welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And enjoy your dinner.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you, Dave. Thank you, Rocky.
See you, Rick. Night.
Bye.
Good night. All right.
Alrighty.
Yeah, he was in here earlier and was having issues with his connection.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll zoom you back in. We'll do a couple that couldn't make it again. Mm-hmm. The next one will be the art.
Okay.
And we're going to make that to Jason and then whatever you want to add.
To Jason.
All right.
Looks yay. Good.
All right. Our next one will be the 8x10 collage.
Okay.
If you can make that out to Rob.
to Rob.
And whatever inscription you'd like to add.
So would it help if once these are all dry, I stick them in the hard thing and write down the name on a sticky on it?
You can. That's up to you. If you don't want to, that's okay too, because I have their inscriptions and their names on a spreadsheet. So if you don't want to do that work, you don't have to.
Okay. I'm just worried if you're not able to read my writing, I guess.
Well, when you hold this one up, I'll look at it and we'll see.
Okay.
But I think I'll be fine. You should see Aiden English's signature.
I should see what?
Aiden English is. His is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, like, see to Rob. Oh, wait, right there.
Yeah, I can read that easily.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, that's easy. All right. Our next one will be the Playboy labeled to Dawn.
The Playboy labeled to Dawn. Yep. Okay. Ramirez.
I love Aiden to death, but I thought my signature was bad. Then I saw his. I'm like, what?
I actually have two signatures. My real one that signs like legal stuff. And then my Christy Hemme one that is actually legible. Because my real one's not legible at all. So it's not
exciting. Mine's terrible. So we're going to make this to Dawn.
Okay.
And then whatever else you'd like to add.
Okay, here's this.
Yeah, see, I can see that's clearly Dawn.
Okay,
yeah,
good. Good.
We're fine. You don't have to do all that extra work.
Okay.
And you're putting the post-it back on it, so we're fine.
Yeah, I didn't do that to all of them, but I started.
That's okay. Yeah, I have a list.
I will tell my husband something really, really quick.
Take your time.
Okay, I'll be right back.
We'll put our ugly mugs back up.
Freeze!
She can hear someone cry. I can hear. I think one of the kids is not happy right now.
There's probably a toddler UFC fight going down in the living room.
Yeah, he's probably like, sweetie, how much longer?
Poor guy. Everybody out in Facebook land, you better get in quick because we're about to finish things up. And then it's sayonara till next Saturday. So if you want to get in here and chit-chat with Christy and get an 8x10, you better do it now. Just say it.
Yeah.
Hey. I'm back.
We were saying that there was a toddler UFC fight going on in your living room.
Totally. And then my sister is over with her kids.
Oh, so boy.
And she has three young ones. And so there's eight kids partying out in my living room right now.
Your husband's like passed out with a bottle of wine in his hand.
No, I just told him, I said, honey, you gotta go make some dinner.
He's like, well, what?
I got it.
He grabs the phone, pizza.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, let's see. Next one is a Hemme 11x14, the art.
Yep.
And we're going to make this to Tim, my favorite Marine.
Oh, I love it. To Tim, my favorite Marine.
Tim normally comes on all these shows, but unfortunately he couldn't make it with us tonight.
Aww. Thank you, Tim.
There you go, Tim. All right. Yeah. Our next one is the 8x10 in the Walgreens. Was it Walgreens tape?
Yeah, my Walgreens outfit.
And you'll just
that's so
sign
magic,
it.
Huh?
No personalization, just signed.
Okay.
And Rocky, check your text message.
I just got it.
All right, perfect. I know sometimes you get busy over there, so.
No problem.
There you go. Sorry you couldn't be with us, Leonard.
Yeah.
All right, so the next one is three items I mailed in. It was two cards.
Okay.
That had little white stickies on it, I think. Yep, that's one of them. I think there's another one.
One card?
Yep, that's just one card. Was there? Oh, no, there's two in there. I'm sorry. Or is it one? Is it a thick, two-sided?
It's really thick.
Yeah. Was there another card, too, or was that the only one?
This is, I think, the only one. Let me look, though, because that could be.
Yeah, because there was, I think there was one more in a little, it was also in a plastic.
Okay.
Cover. If not, we're not going to.
You can take one of my cards.
Yeah, she won't be. We won't go bananas. We'll find it.
Okay.
And then she sent that, not that book, but the other book. There was like a TNA book.
Divas.
Yep. And she has a little note in there for your page.
This one?
The other one. There should be another kind of a paper. Yeah.
Summer?
Yep.
For summer?
Yes, correct.
This one?
Yep.
So I don't see another card. Do you want to take one of my cards?
Yeah, we'll wait. I kind of want to, if we can check the box one more time. I know you're probably like, oh, stupid box.
No, let me look in the box. Hold on.
Maybe it's felt, because it's a little teeny thing. So that's a lesson learned on my part. I'll start mailing them in Ziploc bags. That way they don't kind of fall out all over the place.
I only remember seeing one card.
Okay, if it's two-sided, maybe there was only one and she wants you to sign each side. That's fine. Maybe there was only one and it's two-sided.
Okay.
You're right. There was only one. She got an 8x10 too. So we're good.
Well, do you want me to give her one of my cards? I feel bad.
No, there was only one. I was mistaken. It's two-sided.
Okay.
Was there a little note on the front of the plastic cover?
Gold ink.
Okay. So you'll just sign that.
And just sign it my name?
Yep.
Okay.
On each side.
Okay.
Oh, we see. We she's good now, Rocky.
Yep.
After we finish Summers, we'll do that. Thank you. Perfect.
I'm going to wait to sign the other side because it's wet.
That'll work. And then there's a sticky on her page in that book.
Okay.
And she put, like, I think directions in it. She's very
particular. Oh, yeah, it said summer two cards.
Yeah.
It has two cards.
I probably was wrong. We'll give her one of yours to play it safe. I think she'd like the soccer one.
The soccer one, okay.
Yeah.
Plus, it's the same brand.
Yeah.
Bench warmer.
She'll be happy.
Yeah, good. Okay.
She'll drop kick me later. I'm the one at fault on that one.
It's all your fault.
I don't put responsibility on that. Anyone else but on the person who ships it.
Okay, so then.
And that could be in gold and the same thing. There you go, Summer.
Soccer.
And then whatever's on that page.
Okay.
She's got a giant
sign it with.
She didn't put it. Yep, just sign it.
Okay.
Whatever color you think will look good.
We'll do like Brooke.
Yeah, she's got a bunch of signatures in there.
Yeah.
And then she had a collage 8x10.
Okay.
There you go, Summer.
Yay.
That's a nice book.
It's a great, this is a great book. Okay, and then a collage 8x10.
And you'll make that to Summer.
Mm-hmm. Do the blue. I better keep these all together though, because those don't have names on them. To Summer. This guy.
There you go, Summer.
Thank you, Summer. I'll put the 8x10 in it.
That's smart, yeah.
And the little card. Actually, you know what? I'll put the cards in a pocket protector. And then I'll put it in it.
All right. The floor is yours, Rocky, for a moment.
Rocky! All right.
So we had a late entry.
Okay.
And she's going to pop in and say hi to you.
A late entry! Oh, my gosh!
I'm guessing you guys know each other.
Just a little bit, just a little bit.
You're so cute.
You know what? I'm doing laundry, and then Rocky and David are like, please join us. We're doing the live chat right now. I go, I don't have my face on. I'm doing laundry. Like, I'm in my pajamas. And I
you
like,
look like you have your face on.
I put lipstick on for you.
Those are really cute glasses.
Betsy Johnson at Ross.
So cute.
I can't see.
Thank you for my shirt.
Throw on the shirt. Do you have it right by you or no?
Not right by me. It's in the laundry.
Oh, okay. I got her a Labyrinth t-shirt, and I've had it for 4.5 years. I saw it at a Comic-Con, and I was like, I got to get that for Christy. And I've had it in my suitcase all these years going, okay, we're going to cross paths. Maybe I don't know she's at a Comic-Con or at a something wrestling related, and we might see each other. So I'm like, I better have it. And I've had it for so freaking long. You have no idea.
But what's even crazier is that was the scene that you got on was the theme of my wedding.
Weird. That is so.
And so when I opened up, I was like, oh my gosh, it's my wedding.
Yeah. And then all of you guys know, you don't know, like we used to travel together and I went to go to Vince McMahon and I was like, give me Christy. You know what? She was so new. When you got the Diva Search, we were all behind you because you had such the unique look with the leather, the rocker, and just a character. It's already a character right there.
Yes.
I went to Vince and I said, give her to me. I don't care if I look like an ass. I'm going to make her look good. You know what I mean? And yeah. I was like, please give me to her. And remember,
and then
like,
there was no one that I learned more from.
Oh, stop.
No. That's the truth.
Yeah, do you ever watch when fans tweet it and like our little clippings of what we've done?
Yes, and I think the one that I get the most, actually there's two of them.
The glass.
The widow's peak and the glass.
Oh yeah, but you hurt your, when people said, has anybody got hurt from the widow's peak? And I said, the only person was Christy because you have lordosis, which is a hyper back extension. Like,
yeah.
So she's so flexible and she wanted to make the move look
great. Wait. You didn't hurt me.
But you said it kind of tweaked it a little bit, no?
No. Remember, everybody thought I got hurt. Oh. Because it looked so good.
Because
of my lordosis.
Yes. Your back.
Didn't hurt me.
Hurt you.
Oh. No.
It was the most vicious one I'd seen.
Exactly. So that's why you think that, because it looked so good.
It was perfect execution. I was like, ah.
Don't forget, like Rocky. Christy weighs 105, you know, like, so she's super tiny. And then she was in a bikini, so you could so see the silhouette of the back. Like
she broke me.
Bent in half.
She definitely extended
the wrong way. She was so good, she thought she hurt me.
Yeah. Rocky and David had Ricky Steamboat on the show before. And I was like, I want to say thank you for coming to the ring early on house shows to help Christy and I.
Yes.
In the ring, right? Because I was, remember, like, I had to make up that move that Ricky gave me when I pulled your hair and
dangle. Dangle.
And I said, we called it the dangle dangle.
It was the dangle dangle.
Yes. Oh,
we laughed
God.
About that.
Lisa, do you have your print handy so you can show Christy?
My
your big print. Your big print. Your Mandalorian. No, you're Mandalorian.
Yeah, she's a big Star Wars.
Yes. She's a big Star Wars.
You're Star Wars too?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, dude. Okay, so
girl.
Sasha Banks was in Mandalorian, and I marked out huge. I go,
yes.
The first time in my life, I was like, that was my part. I should have been that character. That is so me. So,
yeah.
So Rocky got this made.
I made that one.
Oh, my gosh. I love it.
And then this is my collage that they made too.
I love it so much.
No, and like I won't do anybody else's virtual signings. I mean, like they are such.
Oh, stop.
No, I'm serious. I've gotten you a lot of people because I'm like, hey, you guys have to do this virtual signing. It's so professional. They pre-sell everything. We're not just going, I got this for sale. Yeah. I got this for sale. You know, and you're like, off. It's very awkward, some of it. Yeah. You know, it's a learning experience. I'm not putting anybody down. I had a good one with High Spots. Don't get me wrong. But, wow.
But I also like, don't you like, Lisa, that you can talk?
Interact. Yes.
Yeah. I didn't like just talking to the camera and not seeing anybody.
I don't either. And then you have to go like pretend like you're doing a promo, right?
Yeah.
It's kind of lonely.
It's a little lonely.
It's more exhausting because you have to put up like, you have to go have like, what is
you don't know what their energy is like in the
middle. You have to build your own energy. You have to build your own energy.
Yeah, and you know who actually you're talking. And to the girl that you just signed, Summer, has come to several of the LA appearances at Frank and Sons. Mm-hmm. That Summer, right, Rocky and David? That Summer?
Yeah.
She's a sweetheart. But they're all regulars on their show. And I remember, like, I was like, hey, drive with me. You know?
Yeah.
You remember, I was like, come drive with me. And she goes,
and hey. I was like, open up your wing because I'm crawling in. I'm in there.
Do you remember asking me, going, who do you think my favorite band is? And I said immediately, AC/DC. And you're like, how did you know? And I'm like,
it's just written on my forehead.
It's just, you elude that. Yeah. Oh my God.
I just seen them.
So great. Oh my God. I can't believe you're a mama.
I'm such a mama. No one's more mama than me.
Oh my gosh.
Five times over.
You don't even look tired.
I just love it. Rocky would text me and be like, hey, can you pop onto this?
No. I'm
like, I can't pop onto anything. I've got like 10 kids. I'm watching.
Oh, did you ask her to pop in on mine?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm literally on the crapper. I can't. No, I'm just kidding.
Did you guys see my last Instagram? I was wishing SoCal Val a happy birthday, and I did it on the toilet. And I go, hold on, let me put the background choir. And I flushed the toilet. I wasn't going to the loo, but I was just.
How's ball going?
Oh my gosh. You're going to be on our show too.
Like, yes, of course.
So great.
Are you having so much fun though?
Yes. This was like, I was trying to tell people, I know COVID was such a bad thing, and it's horrible what everybody's going through.
Yeah.
The positive thing is this happened.
Yeah.
And we're like, it's almost a year.
Yeah.
And it's just growing and growing and growing. And it's only us just, you know how like all FaceTime sometimes, like at home?
How, has what?
You know how we just FaceTime sometimes at home?
Yes.
It's fans like a eavesdrop on that.
They're just basically watching your FaceTime.
Yeah, that's basically.
And that in itself is extremely entertaining.
We've almost sold that red microwave like 6 times.
Oh, my microwave is actually good. Christy, I live in an old, what's our building built in, huh? 1890. So I have to, like, when I'm on these Zooms and these chats, I have to unplug my microwave, unplug my TV Wi-Fi. Because the walls are so thick and it's just an old building. I don't have cable here.
Yeah.
Like, we have Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
It's not the greatest. So I have to unplug everything and just get good reception. You would love the building because you like that, this kind of character kind of building. This is
totally.
Totally.
That's totally. So cool.
Yeah, it's great. It's great. David, here. Hey, Christy. I call her Beebs because she calls her
Beebs. I'm Beebs.
Husband Beebs.
Nice to meet you.
She speaks so highly of you.
Yes.
I love Lisa so much. And she speaks very highly of you as well.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'll pay you later. I'll send you another shirt.
and these two characters are the tops.
They are the tops.
Thanks,
right?
David.
Thanks, Dave.
Honestly, and I talk to them every single day.
Oh my gosh, that's so
I apologize cool. Because I do audio messages only, Christy. You know me.
I love your audio messages.
My big hands. I can't talk.
No texting.
Sometimes her audio messages are.
With texting, you don't always understand what the person means or if they're friendly. You just never know. But when you hear an audio, you know exactly what they mean.
But you guys even said, like, Candace and Tori and like everybody was saying, like, wow, is Lisa mad? Because I replied, yes. Okay.
Totally.
Because I'm not a great texter.
So when she texts us, we think she's mad at us.
And I'm not.
Because she's so vibrant. But her texting is not vibrant.
We thought we made her mad because we never heard anything back from her.
Yeah.
We're like, she's not coming.
It's been 2 days. What is going on?
I know. I needed a break, man.
I know.
It's fine. You're fine.
I was like, I do also voice to text. So I forget to say period, question mark. I don't read it back. So it's like, I don't know what you're saying. And I'm like, I can't text. Forget it. You know what?
Yeah.
And I don't like to talk on the phone. So I'm the worst.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I hope you did great. I hope you had a great experience with Rocky.
I had a fantastic experience. I mean, I really enjoy the whole being with them.
It's so and doing the face-to-face time with the fans. Mm-hmm. It's it's really cool because they get to ask questions and it's long. They get longer time. You guys get longer time this virtual signing
than
what you would get at a meet and greet at a comic con.
Because there's not a person standing right behind them. And I'm like, oh, got to get to them.
Yeah.
And I feel bad. I can't see anybody. So I don't know.
Right. Okay. I love you.
I love you so much.
I know it's 3 hours ahead and you want to go to sleep and you have kids. But I love you. And
I miss you a ton.
I miss you. Take a picture of you in the shirt.
I will so. Take a picture.
I love you, Christy.
Love you.
I love you, Rocky, David.
Kisses.
Bye, Lisa.
See ya.
All right.
She's the best.
The best.
I cannot say enough about her. Like, she just has, and I'm so happy that WWE put her in the stuff that they've been putting her in because she just deserves all the recognition for what she's done for the business.
She's this close from the Hall of Fame.
Oh, she's a shoo-in for it. Like, everybody has been waiting.
I'm waking up any day now. I'm like, hello.
Yeah. She's incredible.
Let's finish up what little bit is left. We're almost done. Okay. So there should be another magazine in that plastic that's unlabeled.
Yep. I got one magazine left.
Yep. And we're going to make that to Tim. And just any inscription you'd like.
To Kim.
Tim. T-I-M.
Kim.
Yep.
I'm glad
it did
said
sound that. Like I said Kim. Yeah.
Kim, Tim. Isn't it nice when somebody's so enjoyable to work with?
Yeah. And she's very responsive too. It's great. It's got it. It's and she's so happy all the time.
She is.
Right. Our next one is the Walgreens 8x10.
Okay. The what?
We're just gonna call it Walgreens.
It totally is.
We're gonna make that to Darren, D-A-R-R-E-N. And then any inscription you'd like.
Okay.
Looks good.
Yes.
All right. Our next one will be the Playboy 8x10.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to make that to Sean. S-E-A-N. All right.
Okay.
Our next one is going to be the Walgreens 8x10.
Okay.
You're going to make this to Peter, my biggest fan, hugs and kisses, Christy. Mm-hmm. There we go. Yay. All right. Our next one is going to be that hardback book.
Okay.
And I, this is my fault. I apologize. I should have labeled it, but we need to look for your page. There should be a page with you on it.
Hey, I already signed it.
Go to your page. Though. Okay. There should be a page.
This crazy look.
Yeah, she probably already had you sign it before. This book's been around.
Looks like my photo.
This is for, this was Lisa's book at one point. So there should be a page with you on it.
So here's Trish and I. Well, it's kind of Trish's page. Let's keep going. Oh, there's me.
Yep.
Like that?
Yep, and you'll just sign your page. Since you already signed the cover, we don't know when. Right. Lisa owned the book, so maybe you were with Lisa or who knows.
Do you want me to sign one of the other pages too?
You can if you'd like. He probably wouldn't be against it.
Yeah. I've already got it open.
He'll probably pass this around if we ever get Trish or Stacy or I think Tori's in there too somewhere.
Yes. Michelle McCool, Tori, Trish, me.
Maybe The Undertaker will let us borrow McCool one day.
Right. <For a show. laughs> Right. Okay. There's Lisa.
Yeah, that's an awesome book.
Yeah, there's a lot of good ones in here. Candace. Lillian. Maria. Stacy.
Yeah, he also bought that hat Lisa was wearing in the book from her.
Oh, cool. There's me. We'll do this one and then that's it.
Yeah, that'll work. Hey, Omer, you got a steal there, buddy. She did two extra pages for you.
So cool. Okay.
All right. Our next one will be the Playboy 8x10.
Mm-hmm.
He asked for it to be in blue. And then you can just sign it. And then put in whatever inscription you'd like.
So this is just signed, not to anybody.
Correct. Here you go, Dom. Sorry you couldn't be with us.
Yeah.
All right. Our next one is going to be the red bikini card.
Okay.
And we'll make this to Marco.
Marco.
Yep. Marco.
Is that Marco from earlier?
Yep. He also got an 11x14 print.
Okay.
And he'd like you to sign that to Marco. Thanks for being a fan and for all the support. Best wishes. Hugs and kisses, Christy.
Okay. Wait, say it one more time.
To Marco, thanks for being a fan and for all the support. Best wishes always. Hugs and kisses, Christy. Thanks for the support, Marco. You got a bunch of stuff.
Yeah. Good stuff.
Yeah, you did.
Okay.
And then our next one will be the card in the white bikini.
Sorry.
The card and
white card you're wearing. White? Yeah, it's like a one of your trading cards, and you're like in a bikini. Yep. And then let me see how he wanted that signed. And this will be the last piece that's live. The other three will be off camera.
Gotcha. Okay.
See how he wanted it. Give me 1 second. Bum, bum. Lag.
You might want to, like, after she's done with the card, hold up Marco's poster.
Okay. Oh, yep. Here.
Because he'll ask. I know he will.
Yeah.
There you go.
Got the sun coming in and getting me.
All right. If it'll fit, I know it's a small card. He'd like you to write to Brody, B-R-O-D-Y, your signature, and then if you can do XOXO.
Yep.
And then he also asked if you can give him a shout out.
Brody, this is for you. Thank you so, so much.
There you go, Brody. Sorry you couldn't
Thank
be with
you,
us.
Brody.
All right, and that's it for our on-cam signings. The three gentlemen that got the other items will do that offline.
Cool.
Did you have any final words for your fans, Christy?
My final words are this. Thank you so much to Asylum. You guys are awesome. I really, really, really enjoyed this. I think your setup is fantastic. You guys are so professional from the beginning when we first talked up until now. So thank you guys so much. Everyone that came in today, all the fans and everybody that's just supporting us doing appearances and continuing to communicate with fans live, thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. I really, really enjoyed this. I hope that things start to open up more so that everybody can get together in person. But man, I just really had a blast. Thank you guys, all of you.
We had a blast having you.
Yeah, you guys.
Thanks for coming.
I can see why Lisa loves you so much.
Well, you're going to make me blush.
You should blush.
Hopefully we can have you back down the road.
Of course. Yeah, I'm in.
We'll do another one.
I'm not going far.
I have to say, since you live in Oregon, how close are you to the treehouse thing? You know what I'm talking about?
No. Yeah. What's the treehouse thing?
They have, it's called Treehouse Masters on HGTV, maybe?
Okay.
Or Discovery. And the guy just builds treehouses. And he has like a resort somewhere in Oregon where you can stay in a treehouse, and it's like 30, 40 feet up in the air.
Holy
I mean, this is like
in a treehouse. I want a treehouse.
Look it up.
Okay, I'm looking it up.
If you go, I want to know about it because I would love to come out there and do that.
The first thing I thought of when you said that was the Enchanted Forest,
right?
Which is like a kind of like a theme park that's built into a mountain,
right?
And it's all nursery rhyme.
Ah.
Theme. It's really cute. Cool. So like Red Riding Hood and all that stuff. And they have this whole, like, you walk around and it's so cute.
Kids would love that.
Oh yeah. And it's very green and it's built into a mountain. It's super cool. There's lots to do.
Another thing to put on my list.
Yes. So yeah. Treehouse, the Enchanted Forest.
Exactly.
Well, and McMiniman's.
Perfect.
Have you heard of McMiniman's?
I think I have.
So they are a family-owned company that buys historical land sites.
Right.
Schools, old insane asylums, like old, like big buildings. And they renovate them and turn them into really cool restaurant hotels. And they have secret rooms. The whole thing is very 70s psychedelic.
Oh, yeah.
And so it's all music and, like, I mean, it's just so cool.
The carpets make your eyes hurt when you look at them.
Yeah, you're like, whoa.
I'm going to have to check that out, too. Yeah. So thanks again, Christy. We enjoyed having you. Hope to have you again in the future. And thanks to everybody that joined us tonight. We had a blast. Stay tuned next Saturday. We have the beautiful Brooke Hogan joining us. So that will be 6 p.m. also Eastern time. So we will see you then.
Bye. Yeah,
stay with us a couple extra minutes, Christy, offline.
I'm with you.
Thank you. See you guys. See you next weekend.